Hard to believe. Seems like the week just started. It's Friday, the 12th day of August, 2016. We're going to have open phones throughout the four-hour transmission today. And we are going to have, of course, a former campaign head for Donald Trump, Roger Stone, popping in with all the latest developments at the bottom of the hour. Then we have Pastor Manning joining us in the third hour. But I do intend to take a lot of phone calls today or do my best to get to many as I can. Just a decade ago, so-called MSM, state-run, corporate-run, global-run media, crony capitalist media, monopoly media, establishment media, whatever you want to call it, they would deny that the Federal Reserve was a private consortium. They would deny that there was a move for world government or carbon taxes. They would deny that there were plans to get rid of nation states' borders. They would deny basically everything you see them admitting they're doing today. They would deny that the Bilderberg Group even existed. Now the Bilderberg Group puts out press releases. And so what happened to the credibility of the people that were talking about those subjects? It went up. What happened to the credibility of the individuals that said it didn't exist? It went down. But still, you have a unified dinosaur media, hundreds of outlets on television and cable and thousands of newspapers, that despite the fact that their power is massively diminished, when they all combine forces together, you know, the Wonder Twins activate, form of a pterodactyl. Well, the globalist Wonder Slobs activate, form of traitors, form of hoaxers. But I'm telling you, they're on their last legs, folks, and economics show that. Their ratings continuing to go from an ocean to like a drying pool in the African savanna. Compared to the power of the mainstream media 50, 60 years ago, it's the Atlantic Ocean compared to Lake Travis outside Austin, Texas. It's a good-sized lake, but you pull back from the topography with a satellite, it's tiny compared to the Atlantic Ocean. And it's now watching them try to come up with new systems to try to revive themselves is wild. And their latest talking point is to just hide it in plain view. MSNBC, CNN, ABC, all of them are in the news today saying, of course we're for Clinton. It's like MSNBC had that talking point. Of course we're arresting Tea Partiers and not giving them 501c3 and shutting down conservative churches. You're a racist. You deserve it. We've dehumanized you. That's one step away from locking people up. They like to lock us up. Just like there's now lawsuits involved, it's been confirmed that there are secret meetings going on with a whole bunch of different states' attorney generals to begin indicting man-made climate change deniers. We're going to go to break and come back with CNN. And in fact, let's go out to break with them just briefly here admitting. Here's the first part of the clip.
Quite a while longer. Mm-hmm. What happens to other folks who want a chance
problem
to run against her?
Because she's doing what they call in politics, freezing pockets. Because the donors are giving her money thinking she's going to run. That means they're not going to have available money for other candidates if she doesn't. And I don't think she's going to give it to them.
She's on her way to deciding.
We'll see.
About deciding.
We couldn't help her any more than we have.
I know.
You know what I mean? She's got just a free ride so far from the media. We're the biggest ones promoting her campaign. So,
and of course, Cuomo's a total political operative. Stay with us. We'll be back. And in a republic, you can have 51% of people vote to enslave the other 49, but you can't do it because it's limited under the confines of the charter of that republic. And that's why the republic became the model of the world after the United States set up this particular type of republic, a limited democracy. And it created fantastic innovation and wealth. That system competes with the globalist technocracy and is being pulled down in front of our very eyes. And the folly of the fake intellectuals believing that they're part of the power structure when they are being prepared like wheat at the fall of autumn for the grim reaper to come with his sickle and lay them low. But I guess God is kind to the stupid because they never even know what hit them. They never even see how they become poorer over the years, and they never know why. And when I say poor, I mean culturally poor, empty, disempowered, disembodied, laid low. Big broadcast today, obviously. I am going to have to be a big boy and really try to be professional and focused here to get all of this information out. There is a new trend that we've noticed by the White House press secretaries and by the State Department secretaries and others to just say, we're lying to you, there's nothing you can do, and then laugh at you. They're just going public with what they've been doing for a long time. Gruber saying, thank God you're so stupid and don't have a memory. We're going to rape you hard. We're going to triple your prices. You know, start sniggling and sniggering and just... you talk about dishonorable filth, they are it. But there's an article that's the top of drudgereport.com. It's also up on Infowars.com from The Observer. Tech companies, Apple, Twitter, Google, and Instagram collude to defeat Trump. They admit they meet at the White House and get talking points. They admit that they fix the search results and block news and only promote negative news against Trump. They admit they've put up a hedge around Trump so you never hear what he actually said. Just they tell you what he said out of context. It's so frustrating to actually see them get away with this with the low information voter out there. It really is amazing. But we're going to be getting into some of that today. Speaking of protective wall to keep the public from actually getting the truth, there's photos out. We're going to be showing the TV viewer side of this, but the article's up on Infowars.com. This is the type of report I ought to send my reporters out to do, to show Al Gore's houses and show Bill Clinton's houses. I mean, these people, no exaggeration, last time I checked, Hillary had something like 14 houses. One of them was something like 20,000 square feet. I had a 4,000 square foot house and downsized it because I wasn't using it. It was a hassle. You imagine a 20,000 square foot house and they don't even put solar panels on them. They just bitch at everybody telling us that, you know, we should use new innovative energies. It's also they control the economy. The American Mirror has the photos. Hillary Clinton's protective wall around her estate, Chappaquiddick Estate, and it is just a giant fortress with, of course, a bunch of black sedans protecting her. They've got the guest house filled with the guard. And is it not lost on her minions? By the way, guys, let's grab it. I saw it this morning on Fox News. There's an amazing new NRA ad that I want to run on my show for information purposes, where it shows Hillary, an actress that looks like Hillary, getting on a jet. And then she's sitting there giving speeches about, you know, caring about the average person. And the whole point is she has armed guards and you don't. So I really want to keep hammering that point. We're going to get to ISIS terrorist tells feds he has jihadist brothers in Mexico. And this is going on in the exact same area that has been confirmed by Judicial Watch, the FBI, and Joe Biggs to have ISIS recruiting centers and mosque operating, and they've linked up with the cartels, which has been confirmed in arrests that have been made previously. So I think it's time to probably deploy Joe Biggs back down there. And the FBI met him at the airport. He was flying out of that particular city that he was in, there on the Texas side, El Paso. And they said, wow, we will not even send agents into where you just went. I mean, it's the place that the movie Sicario is based on. That I've talked to a lot of folks that have been involved in those missions, including family. And they say that movie is deadly accurate. I mean, just bam. It's almost like a documentary because they changed the names to protect the innocent. It is. It's a lot of films you go see that you just think are Fiction, they're not. That's why it was so powerful. I got nauseated on the film about Gary Webb, Kill the Messenger, because I knew Gary Webb, and I know that case closely, and I know what he went through, and that movie is like a documentary. It is sick. I have a lot of respect for the director and the folks that funded that film. It's a famous actor, but I don't really follow Hollywood. What's his name, Renner? A lot of respect for that guy. No, Josh Brolin's in Sicario, the guy that's in Kill the Messenger. He's the famous actor that's, Reiner. He got famous in Hurt Locker. Yeah, Jeremy Renner, we are teleprompter free, but that doesn't mean sometimes I don't like call on the 5-6 people in there and go, does anybody know this? We don't use Google all the time. We use our brains. Yeah. But I am digressing. There is so much to go over today. Americans are still giving up their citizenship at record rates. Friends of DNC linked Sean Lucas, who was shooing over Bernie Sanders openly being robbed, getting killed. His friends are freaked out by that, as well they should be. Obviously, the big news, top Clinton State Department aide helped Clinton Foundation. It's come out. There's now a criminal investigation going on by the Department of Justice and the FBI. The problem is, we have a lady named Loretta Lynch who won't let any of that go forward. So Hillary, I'm convinced, could eat a child, barbecue a baby on the White House lawn. And they would say the baby deserved it, the baby was racist or something. Long as it's a white baby. 45 times Secretary Clinton pushed the trade bill she now opposes. I'm going to play a few of these. I mean, there's 45 of them, and in the interest of time, I'm not going to play it all. But here's Hillary yesterday giving her plagiarized speech, basically from Trump, when she's one of the main authors of NAFTA, of GATT, of globalism, of these one-sided deals. That's on record. And then we have her all these dozens and dozens and dozens of times, however many dozens 45 is, saying she's for the TPP. And, of course, it's okay that Obama's for it, some foreign group, unelected, raping us economically further, because he went on a late show and they sang a song, a jazz song, and he goes, you down with TPP? And Obama said, you know me. They had some cool jazz guys up there with saxophones. Yeah, well, yeah, it's fun. It's fun to get screwed over. So let's hear from Hillary a few years ago. Well, let's hear from her yesterday first.
I will stop any trade deal that kills jobs or holds down wages, including the Trans-Pacific Partnership.
And she nods her head.
I oppose it now, I'll oppose it after the election, and I'll oppose it as president.
Notice she said, though, any deal that isn't good, she'll do whatever she wants. Now let's go to just part of the 45 times. I'm not going to play it all, but this is her over the last 5-6 years. Here it is.
The United States is engaging in the Trans-Pacific Partnership trade negotiations. We're pursuing a regional agreement with the nations of the Trans-Pacific Partnership.
She's running.
We are also pressing ahead with negotiations for the Trans-Pacific Partnership. Trans-Pacific Partnership, a new free trade agreement.
We are very committed to the Trans-Pacific Partnership.
The Trans-Pacific Partnership. The Trans-Pacific Partnership. Trans-Pacific Partnership. Trans-Pacific Partnership. The Trans-Pacific Partnership, the Trans-Pacific Partnership. We should aim for true regional integration. And that is the spirit behind the Trans-Pacific Partnership.
The Trans-Pacific Partnership.
High-quality Trans-Pacific Partnership.
We're excited about the innovative trade agreement called the Trans-Pacific Partnership.
The Trans-Pacific Partnership.
The Trans-Pacific Partnership. The Trans-Pacific
Stop. Partnership. I can't look at her anymore. That's enough. And, of course, they'll say at Media Matters, that's a conspiracy theory. She never said it. I'm not kidding. Because this is weaponized media against you and your family. This is how we're conquered, not by the Nazis or not by the communists, but by multinationals that bought off our politicians, put people in power, and are signing us on to trillions in debt we don't owe, gutting the whole country. Now, when we come back, get ready. We knew it was coming. Let the refugees into your home, they say. And more. We'll also get into the latest dealing with the situation. at the United Nations, where more and more they are admittedly taking over our government. This morning I woke up early at about 5 a.m. and couldn't go back to sleep. And as I often do when I can't sleep, I went in and looked at my children as they slept in bed. I thought to myself, am I doing the right thing, obviously endangering my name, my treasure, my life, when I'm their father and they need me to be here? And then I just fall back on the fact that in my gut, in my spirit, I know it's the right thing to do, to take a risk individually and even for my family, because we're going to lose everything if we don't make a stand. And I say this a lot because it's so true. This isn't rhetoric. The globalists are the most manipulative, evil people the world has ever seen. And that's not my opinion. That's a fact. There is a great global awakening happening. The controlled media, the weaponized media, the enemy media is there to make you feel like you're alone and that you don't count and that we're losing. Well, we're not. And that's why they're so scared of something simple like a Hillary for prison shirt. All over the country, they're trying to persecute college students and junior high students and others. And it becomes local news stories. And they prevail. They win. Because when we resist, it makes the establishment show its true colors. And then they fail. It's only when we submit do they get away with this. And I think about Hillary Clinton out of all the stacks of news I've got here. She, at the State Department, was one of the main negotiators and quarterbacks. In fact, I've got to say the most important, other than Obama, she's the second most important in the last 8 years, globally pushing the Trans-Pacific Partnership. Obama every month was flying off to try to ram this sucker through. And then Congress, remember, couldn't even see it for years. And then finally, you could spend 1 hour but couldn't take photos of the documents, thousands of pages, you know, wheelbarrows full, whole room full of just garbage, one-sided deals that we can't even see, that transfer our power to multinationals. We now have a copy of it. It's a nightmare. It just writes a blank check to do whatever you want, just like Obamacare. And then Hillary sits up there like it's a big joke and says that she will not support the TPP now, or in the future, or basically ever, when she is its mama. Just like she's the mama of ISIS. She brought them in. She set them up in Syria. She brought them in. She set them up in Libya, in Egypt, in Iraq, on record. Those are the emails coming out that WikiLeaks is about to release. I don't need all those emails. We know the troops were ordered to do it. We've had the whistleblowers on. Members of the Senate have gone public. It's all a fact. The head of Defense Intelligence has gone public. General Flynn. And Assange thinks that'll get her arrested or indicted. You see, here's what happened. People in the military and even NATO said, we're not shipping high-impact weapons to Wahhabists flying frickin' Al-Qaeda flags. There is no God but Allah. It's the Wahhabi flag. It's the Al-Qaeda flag. Because they land and start offloading them, and these guys were so arrogant, they would. I've talked to the people that have witnessed it. We're going to kill you next. And you know, they're very crazy. And it was just total breakdown 5 years ago in the military when they were ordered to do this. And then Trump comes out and talks about it, and they act like he's crazy. And then I was thinking back, because we're going to get in clips from a few years ago when I was calling her the founder of ISIS. We're about to play those clips coming up. We've dug them up. And we've got clips of Hillary saying Donald Trump's the founder. In fact, print some articles for me, folks. Remember that 2-3 years ago? She said he, right when he first started running, like a year and a half ago, she said he's the recruiter. He's the head of ISIS. Remember all that crap? So they're saying he's a kook for saying it about her when she actually did it. It's amazing. But here's just one more nugget of her saying the TPP is the gold standard. But now she's fighting it. Now she was never for it, won't be for it, and won't be for it in the future. Here's a clip.
So it's fair to say that our economies are entwined, and we need to keep upping our game, both bilaterally and with partners across the region through agreements like the Trans-Pacific Partnership, or TPP. Australia is a critical partner. This TPP sets the gold standard in trade agreements to open, free, transparent, fair trade, the kind of environment that has the rule of law and a level playing field. And when negotiated, this agreement will cover 40% of the world's total trade and build in strong protections for workers and the environment.
Oh, yeah, so now we got a
copy of it.
It's the worst thing
the
ever seen.
Empire's on the run.
In fact, it allows slavery.
Alex Jones.
Actually allows slavery. Sean Lucas was an IT specialist, high level, kind of like an Edward Snowden inside the DNC.
To take you in the sun to promise.
We're going to be breaking down today election fraud in this country. We're also going to be getting into several articles that Paul Joseph Watson has been writing on the different mysterious deaths. People filing lawsuits being found killed, people that are IT specialists being found shot in the back multiple times. We're going to be breaking all of that down here today as the Clinton body count only seems to expand and get worse by the minute. We've also had Donald Trump coming out in the last few weeks and saying we should be worried about election fraud. They're rigging Google. They're rigging Facebook. They're rigging Twitter. They are rigging polls on record. They've got all sorts of different programs out there to manipulate how they do these polls. They're declaring Trump unfit. Foreign leaders, the Pope, the president, but they won't try to steal the election from him on election day. Roger Stone's here to talk with us about that here in a moment and more. And there's also a CBS news story. Hackers demonstrate how voting machines can be compromised. And then it just goes into the long admitted history of massive fraud and the fact that every major election has been compromised at one level or another by the media consortium, formerly known as Voter News Services. It has a new name and then a new name. It's always changing its name so you can't find it, that announces who the winners are and coordinates at the state level. So we'll talk about that with Roger Stone here in just a moment. Before I go any further, this broadcast is listener supported. This broadcast operates thanks to what you do. And that's why we sell items that I personally have checked out, that I personally use, that I know are a great deal. Whether it is nutraceuticals or whether it's a Hillary for Prison shirt, all of it is either good for you, something very useful in your life, or something that helps basically expose the corruption that's taking place. We've got 33% off on solar base stations and solar panels. Highest quality units out there. Very low prices. We've got specials going on colloidal silver. 50% off on silver bullet. Unheard of. $9.95. The exact same stuff under another label sold at Whole Foods for over $20. We have a lot of other specials that are running as well. 20% off on Alexa Pure Gravity Fed water filters. Without your support, obviously, we will not be able to continue on. We're doing pretty good right now, but I've put on all sail. That's an old naval term for back in the days of sailing ships. Put on all the sails you can to try to go as fast as you can, to try to hire as many crew members as we can and writers and researchers to fight the globalists and to take on the New World Order. And right now you can see that InfoWars is right there at the tip of the spear, punching through the media narrative, punching through their lies and injecting reality. Whether it's Hillary being the founder of ISIS, that's on record. Or whether it's the fact that there's election fraud and rigged polls, that's on record. And we're punching that out there over and over and over again. You, the audience of this show, are the reason we're so effective. So I want to salute you. I want to thank you. And I want to just tell you that your continued support is absolutely essential to the fight against the globalist. InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com or simply call toll-free 888-253-3139. Now, going to Roger Stone. Roger Stone of StoneZone.com. So much has happened since I talked to you Sunday. I've thrown out a lot of topics, a lot of issues. Where should we start? What's front and center?
Well, it's very hard to know where to start, Alex. I mean, first of all, you have the question of voter fraud, more precisely, election theft. I mean, voter fraud itself, while not non-existent, as the left would tell you, is essentially more limited. The larger problem here is election theft, the manipulation of what used to be known as the Diebold machines in common usage across the country. Now, if the Clintons would steal the election from Bernie Sanders, the nomination, as the DNC WikiLeaks proved they did, why would they not steal the election from Donald Trump if they can? I know among political elites they poo-poo this idea, but from a technological point of view, this stunning video put up by CBS, not Breitbart, not Town Hall, not Daily Caller, not InfoWars, CBS, shows how simple and easy it is to program the voting machines for a desired result. The polls, the manipulation of the polls, Reuters got caught red-handed, a number of others have, that's the precursor to the fix of the machines. In other words, you condition people to expect a Clinton victory, and then you deliver that exact victory in the polls. How can this be combated is the question most Trump supporters ask me. And there are several ways. First of all, in the window that we have, 60 days, I advocate locating and registering a million new Trump voters in the very states that will be up as a potential to be stolen. You can go to Restore, let me just get it exactly right, I think it's restoreamericasgreatness.org, where there's a very active effort to locate and register new Trump voters. In states like Ohio and Pennsylvania and New Jersey and Colorado and Iowa and others that will be up for grabs. Secondarily, we're going to need an army of trained poll watchers, people who know what to look for. I am seeking to contact and retain some of the country's leading experts on the computer manipulation of these machines to advise us. And then lastly, I think it is very important that every single Trump voter be found and turned out. I don't have the confidence that the Trump campaign will be able to cover every precinct, but I think perhaps with grassroots assistance, they will be. So we will be unveiling a comprehensive program shortly to combat this election theft.
Speaking of that CBS news report, hacker demonstrates how voting machines can be compromised. If you go to YouTube and type in election fraud U.S., you will see hundreds of newscasts, hundreds of experts, Diebold chief engineers, congressional legislature testimony, local legislatures in Florida and Ohio, and certified fraud and admitted fraud. And I mean, there's famous examples. But for Obama to go, election fraud, what's that? I mean, it's like Hillary saying, what's Turkey, when the Armed Services Committee asked her about the Turkish ambassador. I mean, they just play stupid over and over and over again. Here's a clip from that CBS News piece. I got to say, good job for CBS News actually doing some real reporting.
Concerns are growing this morning over the possibility of a hacked presidential election. Experts believe a cyber attack this year could be a reality, especially following the hack of DNC emails.
The ranking member of the Senate Homeland Security Committee sent a letter Monday to the Homeland Security Secretary. It said in part, election security is critical, and a cyber attack by foreign actors on our election systems could compromise the integrity of our voting process. Maria Villarreal is in Los Angeles to show us how this could happen and if there is a fix. Maria, good morning.
Well, good morning. Roughly 70% of the states in the U.S. use some form of electronic voting machine. Hackers tell me the problems with these machines have been around for years. The system and the computer are both old and antiquated. With millions expected to hit the polls in just 3 short months for the presidential election, security experts are now raising some red flags.
And I'm afraid the election's going to be rigged, I have to be honest.
For weeks, Donald Trump has told his supporters the outcome of the 2016 election could be out of his control.
Good question.
But for the hackers at Semantic Security Response, election day results could be manipulated by an affordable device you can find online.
I can insert it, and then it resets the card, and now I'm able to vote again.
The voter doesn't even need to leave the booth to hack the machine.
And how much does that cost?
$15.
So for $15, I could hack the vote?
For $15 and in-depth knowledge of the card, you could hack the vote.
Semantic Director Kevin Haley says elections can also be hacked by breaking into the machines after the votes are collected.
The results go from that machine into a piece of electronics that takes it to the central counting place. That data is not encrypted, and that's vulnerable for manipulation.
How big of a hacking potential problem is this?
Well, there's a huge potential. There are so many places in the voting process once it goes electronic that's vulnerable.
According to a report from the Brennan Center for Justice, one reason these voting systems are so vulnerable is their age.
We found that more than 40 states are using voting machines that are at least 10 years old.
Our system is as secure as we can possibly make it.
Denise Merrill, president of the National Association of Secretaries of State, says the lack of funding keeps most precincts from updating their systems, but all machines have to meet specific government standards.
The idea of a national hack of some sort is almost ridiculous because there is no national system.
In fact, the more than 9,000 voting districts across the country all have different ways of running their elections down to the type of machine they use. But Merrill says there are checks in place to prevent fraud.
Our voting systems are heavily regulated. They're tested both before and after. There are paper trails everywhere. By and large, I would say the American election system works very well.
CBS learned that only 60% of states routinely conduct audits post-election by checking paper trails. But not all states even have paper records, like in some parts of swing states like Virginia and Pennsylvania, which experts say could be devastating. The Election Assistance Commission told us that they ensure all voting systems are vigorously tested against security standards and that systems certified by the EAC are not connected to the Internet. Gail?
Well, less than 100 days, we're going to the polls. Thank you, Maria, very much.
Good to see. All right, I'm going to go back to Roger Stone on this, but he wanted us to air this piece, and I'm glad we did. Now, I say good job admitting at least that these machines are easy to hack. It's happened many times. But at the end, they totally deceive the public. Maybe they're ignorant. So let me enlighten CBS right now. Right after Kennedy got killed, they started having the Associated Press coordinate with the states, and then it would announce who the winner was. Then they changed the name in 1990 to Voter News Services. And by the way, Mr. Stone has been part of famous recounts at the highest level, so he's an expert. We'll speak to him in a moment and skip the break to have more time. But every major election, if you just Google Voter News Services, they've had so many problems, they changed the name in 2003 to National Election Pool, but was set up by the exact same group. So again, it was AP announced that Bernie Sanders was going to win by a certain point the day before because they, quote, met with the superdelegates at a rich person's house. Oh, I see. But they went ahead with the election. What they do is they will fix it in key battleground states, steal it, and then have it called by this private consortium headed up by AP to go ahead and announce hands down what's happened. And then later, it's hard to do a recount. Now, that's a layperson's breakdown of that, Roger Stone, StoneZone.com, former campaign head for Trump. But is that pretty accurate, what I just said?
Yeah, I think everything you said is accurate. I'd make a couple points about the CBS video. First of all, it's not foreign actors I'm worried about. It's domestic actors, those who have custody of the machines. The woman at the end of that video who says, well, the machines are heavily regulated, exactly. It's the regulators I'm worried about. So, for example, the Diebold PES machine is in wide use in California. They're in the custody of the Secretary of State. I attempted to reach him. His name is Alex Padilla. I couldn't find him, unfortunately. He was out campaigning for Hillary Clinton. I remember well when the Democrats went out of their mind because the Florida Secretary of State, Catherine Harris, was actively campaigning and had a title in the Bush campaign. But you have an identical situation here in California. The machines are fixed after the fact. They keep the same number of votes. They just rejigger the total. And they've already laid the groundwork by manipulation of the polls. Unfortunately, this is also how you detect the fraud. If you take an honest poll, and we intend to do that, and then compare the results on a precinct basis or on a subdivision basis, and the swing from the poll to the final results defies the mathematical odds given the time frame, then you have prima facie evidence of fraud.
On its face, you have it. And expanding on that, Roger Stone, exit polls from my research are generally, depending on who conducts them, 3 to 5% margin of error, very accurate. So we need to conduct exit polls in these key precincts, key battlegrounds, to immediately cry foul if something doesn't show up that we expect to see from the real polls.
Very definitely a part of the plan that we are putting together to protect Donald Trump from election rigging. Trump himself, I think, has played a vital role already.
Raising awareness.
By heightening public awareness to this very real problem. I mean, it is almost laughable in terms of the last couple of days, Alex. First of all, I myself have been hacked into my personal accounts, my business accounts, my political work. A number of my bank accounts have been accessed all within the last 48 hours. As soon as it became publicly known that I was in communication with Julian Assange, now there is a massive effort on Twitter and Facebook to discredit Assange. That's because the Clintonistas know that Mr. Assange, who I believe is a hero, who's fighting the deep police state, they know Mr. Assange has all of the emails that Huma Abedin and Cheryl Mills, Hillary's flunkies, thought they erased. Now, if those emails were worth taking the public heat for having erased them, it tells you that what's in them is extraordinarily significant. So now there is a giant effort online to discredit.
This is Roger Stone hacked up. You're talking to, you know. Well, I tell you, I'm just trying to think of the headline I should go with here. Roger Stone hacked after talking to Assange. I mean, this is like an espionage movie. And then we've got Democratic press communications PR agent hired to shut down Seth Rich conspiracy theories, and it's a top consultant that works for the Clintons. This guy shot four times in the back, high level, dealing with the emails. And then Assange telegraphs on Dutch TV that he's the source and that these bombshells are about to come out. This is amazing.
Yeah, there is a giant effort online. These are the twerps that correct the record, constantly saying that we, the Trump supporters, are trying to stage a constitutional crisis based on rigging this election. I say to you, no, Alex, those who are causing the constitutional crisis are the ones who are rigging the machines. All we want is an honest count. If we have an honest count, there's no question in my mind that Donald Trump, despite the beating he's taking from the mainstream media, distorting and twisting and focusing on everything he says, while giving Hillary largely a free pass on the startling revelations that she's now under investigation through their foundation at the IRS, that she did indeed arm ISIS. I mean, come off of it, David Brock. She armed ISIS. It's an undisputable fact, no matter how many.
I was about to say, they can't run from this. I mean, there's a sense of this is just mounting by the minute, and then real liberals like Assange, who exposed Bush for bad stuff, and we thank him for that, I said, we'll know if he's for real if he goes after Obama and Hillary. He's been doing that, and I tell you, he's a real hero. I wish he would go ahead and release the data dump now. I understand it might have more power if he did it a month before the election, but I tell you, we need to bring Hillary down now, Roger.
Well, I think he may choose to release it before each one of the debates, release some emails just before the debates so that Hillary has...
Well, for your safety and everybody's safety, because obviously they hit your emails and took over your bank accounts and everything, governmental level, to find out what you're up to, what you're doing. Just for everybody's safety, Did Assange give you any info? Because I mean, I think if you've got it, you've got to put it out now.
I'm not at liberty to discuss what I have, and I kind of have a foreshadowing, but nobody affects Julian Assange. Nobody tells this guy what to do. He is he understands.
No, obviously, no one's implying that. What I'm saying is, because I mean, we haven't talked about this, because I only talk about stuff like this on record. If I was Assange, you'd be a smart guy to give some data caches to, and I'd be giving it to hundreds of trusted people right now.
Well, I lost some data in the hacking. Some things that I was about to publish, manuscript for my next book on the Clintons, has been stolen. Some other items, nothing that is not recoverable. But for example, my entire contact list, people I deal with regularly, is wiped out. It's gone.
And so by the way, you don't like to bitch and complain, but we have to report this as a war. You're being audited. You've paid them, and they're just saying you didn't pay your taxes
The IRS is harassing me over 2014. I paid all my taxes and everything owed.
And they just say they're ignoring your check. They're ignoring the cash check and your return. They just say you're a criminal and you didn't pay.
Well, first of all, I've been through this. Somebody filed a false return in my name. That means when I went to file my return online, the system kicked me out. I had to hire an attorney. We filed the correct forms, and we paid our taxes. This is all documented in writing in the correspondence between my lawyer and the IRS. Now the IRS has amnesia. Like, none of this happened. We're right back where we were. You never paid your 2014 taxes, despite the fact that I have a canceled check and all this correspondence. No, it's harassment.
It's amazing, and they are pulling out all the stops, folks. I mean, it is incredible. Let's get down to brass tacks here. What is the true nature of the polls? I mean, I see so many that are frauds, but at the same time, I don't want to discount them all. From internal polling, from your own research, where are Trump and Hillary right now in the general election? But also, what about those battleground states? Is he really losing ground there?
There's no evidence that he is. He remains in range. He is ahead in some of the battleground states. Still, I believe he's still ahead in Florida by a point or two. He's behind in others. The gap is not 9 points. It's not 15 points. In every case, he's within range. I must tell you, I never expected in this race for him to be ahead of Hillary until the end. Ronald Reagan was never ahead.
Explain that phenomenon, because you've been saying that for over a year here on the show, that you think it's going to be tight till the end.
Well, first of all, you have so many cataclysmic and big level events here. The debates are going to change the numbers. Whatever Mr. Assange drops and Trump's and Hillary's reaction to it could change the numbers. The country is almost evenly matched between left and right. They've done a better job over the years of voter registration than the Republicans have ever done. There is also now a growing chasm between Trump and the Republican National Committee. Because
I was about to raise that, though. We've got, he's the main fundraiser. He's bringing in big money now. And you've got the old Republican establishment saying, take the money away from Trump, give him nothing. They're openly trying to sabotage things for Hillary because he'll just quit recruiting and getting money, and then that'll hurt all the Republicans. They're obvious saboteurs.
Well, but the other thing that's true is we cannot reach agreement in terms of who ought to be targeted. In other words, there are blue-collar, union-member Democratic votes out there who will go for Donald Trump, but will probably not vote for the balance of the Republican ticket. If you're in the Trump campaign, if you're in the Trump camp, as I am, you want those voters contacted and turned out. The Republican National Committee...
Strategically, we need Trump. Strategically, we need Trump. We can't trust new crops of Republicans that get, you know, taken over every time.
Indeed. And they just want to turn out the Republican vote in order to protect their congressional incumbents. Virginia is a perfect example of this. Trump has great crossover appeal that the rest of the party ticket does not have. We need to be targeting Trump voters, not Republican voters.
Roger Stone, other points that need to be gotten into here. I mean, look, they hire this top Democrat crisis manager to, quote, take over statements for the family in Seth Rich's death. We have other folks, friends of D.C.-linked lawyer that was suing over it being stolen from Bernie. Sean Lucas freaked out by his death. We've got a bunch of other deaths going on. I mean, this smells.
Yeah, you have Alex, the deaths of Seth Rich, John Ash, and Sean Lucas in short order, all of them connected to the heist of the Democratic national nomination by Hillary with the inside mole assistance of Debbie Wasserman Schultz. So, and when you raise this publicly, These are three deaths. You're immediately smeared as a conspiracy theorist. Well, if it were one death, perhaps you'd say, all right, a coincidence. Three deaths? Really? I don't think it's unreasonable to scratch your head and say, why are three insiders with intimate knowledge of the machinations at the DNC that stole this nomination for Hillary now pushing up daisies? That's a entirely...
I'll tell you this. Assange has got giant eggs because... If you look at this, he knows it's hurting Hillary. She's degenerating under the stress daily. Whatever's in these emails has got her scared to death. You can see it. She looks like a cornered, hairless rat. They're totally freaking out. And Assange is just pushing and playing chicken with these folks. This is such a historic time.
Well, and beyond that, it's very clear that Hillary's health is not good. I have reason to believe that the documents that were leaked recently from the hospital in Mount Kisco, New York, which is close to Chappaqua, are...
Oh, you believe those documents are real?
I believe that they are. I am still researching it. I am not finished. But the physical evidence, just the video you can watch of her, and now this mysterious African-American doctor who is with her at all times...
He runs around with a tranquilizer dart. Hold on. I want to see if we can do five more minutes with us or maybe longer. Roger Stone, there's so much to cover. StoneZone.com. We have the new shirt they designed, the Clinton rape shirt, InfoWarsStore.com. All right, we got Pastor Manning popping in later. I want to open the phones up as well. Do five more minutes with Roger Stone. The energy in this country is so over the top. I don't even know what to say anymore. I mean, it is just an amazing time to be alive. The evil, the corruption is so out in the open now that it makes my head spin. And there's got to be a breaking point when we've got Google and all the other computer companies and tech companies admitting they're for Hillary and CNN admitting it and all the rest of the craziness and Hillary obviously so ill and then... MSNBC saying, oh, Trump doesn't sleep enough. He's crazy. He's unfit. This is an incredible time. Roger Stone, in your gut, what do you think is going to end up happening with this election?
I see a narrow Donald Trump win. I see Trump triumphing in these debates because the only thing predictable about Donald Trump is that he's entirely unpredictable. So Hillary will never know where he's going to come. Could it be Bill's history as a sexual predator and Hillary's history of bullying and intimidating his victims? Could it be Benghazi and the arming of ISIS and issues pertaining to her tenure as Secretary of State? Could it be the epic corruption of the Clinton Foundation? Could it be the 1994 crime bill, which incarcerated an entire generation of young black men for nonviolent crimes, including possession of small amounts of drugs? A law that Hillary said was necessary because black people were super predators and had to be brought to heel. It could be any of those things or anything else. So I think that the debates are an opportunity for Trump. I think he will exploit that opportunity. And when you add to that what I think will be the bombshell revelations dropped by WikiLeaks, I think by Election Day, Hillary is thoroughly disgraced.
Do you know, or are you at liberty to give us any other hints? I mean, Assange has said some of it is Hillary sending weapons to ISIS, the total proof. I mean, we know that happened, but it'd be great to have that. Any other hints?
Nothing that I'm able to talk about. I'm not going to upstage one of the great freedom fighters in the world today, Julian Assange.
But you'd a little bird told you, or you just have a feeling that we might see this dribbled out at the debates?
We have mutual friends, and often I was very careful in my words. I never said I met with him, never said I spoke with him. We have communicated through a trusted mutual friend, and he is committed to this course. Nobody is changing his documents. His documents, as always, will be genuine. And I think that he's got information on the entire U.S. establishment power.
And like you said, no Saudi connections, no Russia connections for Trump. He's clean.
He has certainly sold apartments to some wealthy Saudis. He's never met Vladimir Putin. Unlike Hillary, who took huge amounts of cash.
Sure, exactly. Everything she blames Trump for, she's actually doing. So this is just an incredible time Assange, though, when he talks about Hillary, just shakes his head with the info he's got. I mean, imagine what it must be like to just actually see what these people are involved in.
Well, and to make it absolutely clear, and I wrote this for Breitbart, we now know for a certainty that the DNC heist documents were not leaked by the Russians, had nothing to do with the Russians, were hacked and first made public by Crucifer 2 almost a month ago. And when that didn't get the appropriate traction, he took them to WikiLeaks, who then leaked them. So the whole idea that this is Putin, this is the Russians, that Donald Trump and Paul Manafort are somehow in bed with Putin is nonsense. By the way, Putin doesn't particularly like Paul Manafort because Manafort helped convince the Ukrainian president Yanukovych to join the European Union.
No, I know. It's all total bull. All right, Roger Stone, we'll talk to you again soon. Have a great weekend, StoneZone.com. The Clinton rape shirt is up there, folks. Get it, wear it, expose these monsters. Thank you, Roger Stone. It's available at InfoWarsStore.com. We'll be back. Stay with us. I'm going to open the phones up right now. The toll-free number to join us as we enter the second hour is 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. And you're welcome to talk about any of the big subjects that we've been getting into, the deaths of these different Democratic operatives that were exposing election fraud, the latest development where top Clinton State Department aide helped Clinton Foundation while they were working for the State Department, and money being sent from African dictators to the foundation, and then they're given favorable deals. This is something we've all known, but now it's all coming out. Totally illegal. Meanwhile, last hour we played the 45 times Secretary Clinton pushed the TPP, the secret global government deal, masquerading as a trade deal, but now she says she never supported it and will always fight it into the future. Isn't that just special? Meanwhile, I've got this stack of news, and again, we're going to go to your phone calls, 800-259-9231. Let refugees into your homes. France pleads with citizens to help ease migrant crisis. Bring the jihadis directly into your homes. The French government, now Germany's already started this, where you live in Section 8 housing. They say you got to bring them in or you won't get your, quote, free housing. And this is for retirees. They're taking retirees' homes, basically. The French government is struggling to tackle a migrant crisis that they advertised and told folks to come. There are currently 147 reception centers. Oh, reception centers across France. But these are in massive demand as desperate refugees continue to flee the Middle East. So the answer is cater more. That's why they brought down Syria, opened it up as a gateway from the Middle East into Turkey, the famous Muslim invasion route. Housing minister has pledged to build another 50 centers before the end of the next month. Good. But she also called on French people to open up their homes to migrants if needed. Several organizations have already promised to help. The Pope says you should, too, but the Vatican isn't taking one person, and that's 200-foot walls. Two wealthy Sharia Muslims kept slaves in their Texas home. This is from the U.S. Chronicle. They told a judge that Muhammad had slaves and punished them was Islamophobic. That's right. The Texas couple had been found guilty of engaging in forced labor. Hassan al-Hamoud, 46, and his wife, Zanidab al-Hosani, 39, pled guilty to crimes of holding a person against their will and forced labor, otherwise known as slavery. But it's not when Muslims do it. They tried to convince the judge that their actions were acceptable because their prophet, Muhammad, the creator of the religion of Islam, kept slaves of his own. Therefore, any punishment that they received would be Islamophobic. Hopi Indians are allowed to take mescaline. That's their religion. You are allowed to grab slaves and keep them. Loving and liberal. I'm sure the Huffington Post will probably have an article about how we need to be more cuckold and wear burkas. By the way, I didn't get to it yesterday, but there was an article about how Salon's giving up on being a pedophile promotion bureau, and supposedly some Trump / quasi supporter guy is taking Salon over, which is because it's failed. And you've done your kamikaze mission of lying and disinformation and all the rest of it. So now you're going to try to flip back. The new Salon, very different from the old Salon. New CEO adds conservative voices, plans relocations away from political coverage. Well, just please don't have articles with guys salivating over 4-year-old girls in videos. I mean, you know, come on. Conservative leaders call on media to report on genocide of Christians. CNS News, the UN admits it's doubled the last 10 years. There is persecution of Christians at all-time highs. German intelligence, we have evidence ISIS hides hit squads among Syrian refugees. Gee, you have evidence? They told you 2 years ago that in the next migrant wave they were sending in their jihadis. So thank you for telling us that. Twitter secretly censored negative Obama comments in 2015. Oh my gosh, yes, that's on Infowars.com. And it's all coming out, and they're very, very proud of it. Meanwhile, you talk about real police state. I'm going to get to this later. DEA regularly mines Americans' travel records to seize millions in cash. They'll even grab a couple thousand dollars. I mean, when I take the whole family out of the country, in case credit cards got turned off, you know, in case the globalists pull something, who knows? I mean, every adult member of the family takes $3,000 or $4,000. That's what you need. And they'll, boy, coming back in, they're like, what do you got $2,000 for? And I'm like, well, I mean, cash. I mean, they want everybody digitally controlled. And the DEA illegally does this parallel construction where they have all the NSA data. So does the IRS. It's just so criminal. And the big mega banks control the drug trade, and the government knows it. It's like at the end of the movie Sicario with Josh Brolin. They admit that the CIA has trimmed back 10 cartels down to 3 to make it more manageable and controls the drug trade. They just put it in Hollywood films now. Such a joke. We want the cash. DEA seizes millions from travelers, bribes transit employees. Oh, yeah. Yeah, the big secret is when you got a plumber in your house or an air conditioning person or whatever, a lot of them make more money every year as informants off money they get from seizures and convictions than they get off the plumbing job. So they're just looking in your house. There's been cases of them planting things, too. What a society we've created. And again, people say, well, then why don't you support Black Lives Matter? Let's shoot some police. Just because we have a corrupt government and that has corrupt practices that are getting out of control doesn't mean we start a civil war because George Soros wants one. And it doesn't mean the average cop's involved in this. This is the feds, and even the average DEA person doesn't like it and wants it reformed. That's why we know about a lot of it. And just if we, I don't want drug legalization, by the way. I want decriminalization. I want to make it uncool, like they've done in areas of Europe, and it's caused drug use to plummet. I want to make it you're a loser, not some cool guy, and take the money out of it. Because certainly there's a horrible criminal culture involved in drugs. I don't like it. But the whole thing was created at the end of Prohibition because they didn't have a market anymore. Alcohol had been made legal. The very same globalist interests began to make drugs illegal, so they had something new to corrupt the police and control society. Rand Paul says Hillary should get 5 years in prison for lying to Congress about weapons going to ISIS. It's now come out that she was ordering weapons to him and that Donald Trump is right. Come on, link up with Donald Trump, Rand. I know you guys played golf and we're friends. And I mean, please. In fact, speaking of that, here is Rand Paul on Fox News last night.
Let's take a listen to what you asked her back in 2013 Benghazi hearing.
It's been in news reports that ships have been leaving from Libya and that they may have weapons. And what I'd like to know is the annex that was close by, were they involved with procuring, buying, selling, obtaining weapons? And were any of these weapons being transferred to other countries, any countries, Turkey included?
Well, Senator, you'll have to direct that question to the agency that ran the annex. And I will see what information is available. And
you're saying you don't know?
I do not know. I don't have any information on that.
Now, if WikiLeaks, in fact, does have emails proving that she did know, what does that mean to you?
It's a felony to lie to Congress. You can get 5 years in prison. And we can't continue to say that the Clintons are above the law. I do believe that the CIA annex in Benghazi was procuring weapons, some of them to get them away from the jihadists in Libya, but some of it to ferry those weapons through Turkey into Syria. There have been many, many firsthand accounts. New York Times, London Times, Washington Times have all reported upon this. I know for a fact that the current Secretary of State is very very aware of what the CIA is doing, and I can't reveal what I've heard from him, but I can tell you that he's aware of what the CIA is doing in Syria, and I find it hard to believe that Hillary Clinton, who all the news reports have said she was the biggest advocate for arming the Islamic rebels in Syria, many of whom turned out to be not only enemies of ours, some of them may have turned out to be ISIS, but some of them also turned out to be enemies of Israel as well.
May have been. I mean, the Pentagon said like 95% were, quote, Wahhabists. That's Al-Qaeda. That's ISIS. Whatever name you give, it's Wahhabists. The black flag with the white circle on it with the there is only one God and his prophet is Muhammad. Again, Donald Trump is just saying what's admitted fact, and the whore media acts like it's the end of the world. And notice, Trump is bringing all this back out. The attack on our guns, the attack on our sovereignty, the one-sided trade deals, arming the radical Al-Qaeda folks, bringing them into our countries. Where is the fault with this man? But you see the corporate media acting like it's the end of the world. Well, the truth is, he's opening up a wedge for all of us to try to save this country. And for that, we owe him a great debt. Here's the golden toad.
Then Obama came in, and normally you want to clean up. He made a bigger mess out of it. He made such a mess. And then you had Hillary with Libya. So sad. In fact, in many respects, you know, they honor President Obama. ISIS is honoring President Obama. He is the founder of ISIS. He's the founder of ISIS. Okay? He's the founder. He founded ISIS.
Incredible.
And I would say the co-founder would be crooked Hillary Clinton.
By the way,
co-founder.
We have found the compilations. We found the videos going back 2 years ago where I said she is the founder of ISIS and where I said she's the commander of ISIS and that she set up the whole scheme, which you just heard Senator Dr. Rand Paul say, who's on the Armed Services Committee and gets the classified briefings. Well, before they had those classified briefings, I had Colonel Schaefer on from the London Group. He used to head up the anti-Al-Qaeda desk for the Army. And I had Tosh Plumlee and I had Steve Pachinik on to tell you the former head of counterterrorism for the U.S. I mean, I'm not bragging, but we have the guys on, and they told you exactly what happened within a week of Benghazi. I'm just telling you. And Donald Trump is now putting it out there. I've got the enemy attack profile. I know what they're doing. Even before I go out and read their white papers, I know. Sometimes when I go out and read a white paper, it's like I know what the next paragraph's going to say because I know this enemy so well. But during the break, I'm out there. We've got Fox, CNN on these monitors to monitor establishment media. And Wolf Blitzer, who is a foreign agent of Israel on record. I'm not against Israel. It's just like Anderson Cooper's CIA. Tell folks you're CIA. Wolf Blitzer is a liberal leftist Israeli operative, probably Mossad.
Al-Maliki did not want to give maybe 5,000 to 10,000 remaining U.S. troops legal immunity from Iraqi prosecution.
You know, but that's a matter of leadership. Barack Obama should have been able to.
And what is he doing? So let's get into it. I'm out there during that break, and I turn it up, and I'm watching it. And I knew what they were going to say before they said it. They show a clip of Donald Trump in 2007 saying, get out of Iraq. I said, don't go in 2003. And they flip it around and go, he's a private citizen. And he screwed up. We should have stayed. But Obama screwed up worse. So they're saying Obama's bad and so is Trump because Obama did the pullout in 2010, 2011, which he never did. And then I knew what was coming next out of their fat mouths. That's what gave ISIS the ability to organize and take over and get a third of Iraq and then invade Syria. I mean, I know what they're going to say before they say it. It's so ridiculous. He pulled out of Iraq to create the vacuum on purpose, and they gave them the weapons, and they said in their communiques, and when signs in English, Libya now, Syria's next. And it was an organized plan. So it doesn't legitimize that we ever went to Iraq, because then Obama pulled out and it all went to hell. They took Iraq out as part of the admitted plan that Wesley Clark has talked about and others have. It's an admitted Pentagon plan. It's bipartisan, going back 20 years. Now listen to me carefully here. I ought to get a mobile mic and go over there to the map on the wall and show folks. You have to take out the secular country, Iraq, if you're going to then bring down Syria, its ally next door. And who are you going to import? Sunni Wahhabists to repopulate and take over the area that have vastly larger population numbers. So they gave them the old bases, the convoys, the weapons, the advisors, everything. They go into Libya. Then they go into Iraq. Then they go into Syria. Then they go into Turkey, who gives them free passage in and gives them air support and artillery support to then go into Europe for the next phase. And our government's advertised to bring them in, 80% military-age men, almost all of them with fake passports. They're not Syrian refugees. They are the jihadi invasion force from everywhere, the Caucasus, from the stands, from North Africa, from Central Africa, from Western Africa, from Eastern Africa, from all the way into Central Asia. Everywhere from Chechnya to Pakistan, pouring in with the jihad. And then right behind Hillary, in Orlando, planting the flag, Mateen's father from the gay nightclub, who agrees with his son in TV programs he hosts internationally, standing right behind Hillary on camera for the whole world to see. A message. And we are so fat, dumb, and happy, we have no idea what we're facing. We got a lot of calls. I'll get to you after Pastor Manning pops in. Because like I said, I thought he was on the next hour, not this hour. Time zone issue. He's going to be popping in, and then I'm going to go to your calls for the entire third hour today. And I'm sure going into the fourth hour, the host then will be taking your calls, David Knight. But this is such an incredible time to be alive. Briefly, if you aren't getting prepared, you know, I mean, I'm 70% offense trying to stop the globalists, but I am 30% now just getting the farmhouse ready, getting the solar panels in, already got the well in, making sure I've got a self-defense plan, making sure I've got the basic medical supplies. And I wouldn't be doing that unless I thought it was a very good chance in the next 3, 4, 5 years, maybe even sooner, we're going to see some very serious societal disruptions. The best storable foods, the best solar panel systems and control units, the best colloidal silver, 50% off. It's $9.95 right now. Silver Bullet at InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com. We've got the solar panel control system and panels, 33% off. That's unprecedented. We've got 20% off, or 23% off technically, on the InfoWars Premium Power Pack that jumps your cars 12 times on one charge and has a bunch of different plugs for different devices. All of this is something critical, great prices, and it funds this operation. InfoWarsStore.com. InfoWarsLive.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. And whatever you do, get the Hillary for Prison shirts, because that meme is getting big, and it's a great way to meet like-minded people and support this transmission. Stay with us. We've got the DNC tech operative, high level with their email, who Julian Assange basically said is their source, dead. Right at the time those emails were released. More is coming. We've got other people filing lawsuits that are DNC operatives being killed that were exposed to the fact that Bernie Sanders was robbed. Unprecedented. And now Newt Gingrich, former Speaker of the House, to his credit, has come out. The video's on InfoWars.com and a Paul Joseph Watson article. Newt Gingrich on Seth Rich. If someone gunned down in our Capitol, we should know why. Things are dangerous. Things are going on. Things are dangerous. Things are going on. And this is a message to everybody. You keep pushing, we're going to kill you. And you leak what we're doing, we're going to kill you. Obama has more than quintupled, according to liberal professors like Jonathan Turley, constitutional law, the persecution of the press ever seen. and of whistleblowers. And Hillary says, I came, we saw, he died. And all her always bragging about, and Obama, he's really good at killing people, he said. And now you've got these deaths of lawyers filing lawsuits that are Bernie supporters and DNC people and other folks getting killed. I mean, this is crazy. And you've got these fake polls where they had 15% more Democrat than Republican. I mean, this is amazing. I want to ask Pastor Manning, who's only with us for 30 minutes today. I appreciate his time. We'll go to your phone calls in the third hour today and about 30 minutes from now. Pastor James David Manning, the middle of Harlem, helped bring down to a great extent that corrupt thug Al Sharpton. Otla.org has a lot of courage, always has really interesting angles, a lot of wisdom, always helps me clarify things. I mean, that's why, quite frankly, we have him on. What do you think's really going on? What do you think the real numbers are? I think it's a landslide for Trump, but they're going to try to steal it. What do you make of such a wall of media deception? I've never seen anything like it. What is the real state of the world? Because I got to tell you, Pastor Manning, I've gone from having a lot of concern and feeling the ominous energy build up the last few years to now it's a sickening level where I feel like I'm fighting for my life or something. I mean, I'm waking up in the middle of the night wanting to work. I'm working 7 days a week. I'm breaking out in sweat. It's cold in the studio. I'm not a hysterical person. I get angry. I get motivated. But I'm telling you, I can just feel evil rising. There's also a lot of good happening. But I tell you, what are you feeling in your spirit?
Well, with respect to the evil rising, you're absolutely right. But I think to fully interpret this, we need to go back partially to 2008, where the globalists and New World Order people discovered all of a sudden that they wanted Barack Hussein Obama for president. Now, there are several reasons why he was a better choice than Hillary or John McCain at the time, because they could have gone with either one. But they decided that they wanted Obama, and they went ahead now and put they queued into the computer system of rigging elections, rigging the media, paying the media, and to some degree, assassinations, etc., to get Obama in. I mean, because he was not, and then they began to yeast up all these crowds. In Dusseldorf, Germany, Obama commanded a crowd of 200,000 people, Alex. This isn't even America. But in Germany, because the European New World Order people there wanted him, and they wanted to say that Europe wanted him. So what I think we see happening now is the same structure now being used double time, and Hillary is saying, listen, I sat back, I sucked it up, I didn't squeal, I didn't try to bring down Obama. I didn't try to reveal who all of y'all are, though you paid me well at Goldman Sachs and allowed me to earn a lot of money there. But I want this election. I want it. I don't care who wants Donald Trump or anybody. I want this election. Make it happen. And that's what we see happening.
And we've got the emails to all the media telling them what to do. Incredible scandal.
Well, I mean, that's a part of the process. It's just one of the more components of the way the media handles all of the information. If Julian Assange is pushing out information or Russia's pushing out information, then you get pushback from the dunghead media on these items. And the American people are sitting there asking who they're going to believe, their lying eyes or the media. So that's what's happening.
Do you think they've miscalculated, or do you think they're going to pull this off?
Well, it depends. They could change horses in the middle of the stream. They have no scruples. These are people without a conscience. Quite frankly, I mean, they don't have a heart, so they could change it. Right now, they've gone ahead and said, listen, Hillary, it's yours. You've got it. You're 15 points ahead in Colorado, for crying out loud. You're 4 points ahead in Georgia and 9 points ahead in North Carolina.
Who believes any of that?
Oh, well, listen.
People hate Obama. They hate Hillary. She can't even get crowds of 200 people.
But Alex, people, here, when a Trump supporter hear that Hillary is winning by 9 points in North Carolina, You know, listen, Alex, you would
it
be
makes
going
them give
your,
up hope. That's why they're
right. Absolutely, that's exactly what I want to say. It just defeats them. They feel defeated. I'm not going to the polls. I'm not going into more rallies. I'm going home and get drunk. I'm going to Golden Corral or something, or going to Walmart and buy myself another rifle. That's it. That's what they want.
And people need to stop doing that, like buying a 20th rifle. And I'm not against buying guns, but I'm saying just like, oh, this will make it okay. I can still have this. You need to politically bust your butt, because I'm telling you, I don't get up here and lie, folks. We've shown all the reports. We've done it. Every major polling agency is working with the Democrats now with these public polls. They do internal polls, so the campaign knows what's happening. Trump was 15 points ahead, according to insider polls that were serious polls after the convention. That's why they started sampling 15 points more in these other polls to try to put Hillary ahead. It's totally fake. And I'm not just saying that, but what Manning said is true. It then creates a self-fulfilling prophecy where people then actually believe that's happening. And a lot of folks are on the fence and go, well, I just want to bet on a winner and feel like, you know, I'm with a winner. So, okay, I'm for Hillary now.
Yeah, and the other thing, Alex, I think going back to the purchasing of more rifles, also you got 10, you're going out by the 11th. No, here, listen, I'm all for the Second Amendment. Purchase as many weapons as you need to protect yourself, your family, your country. But here, we need to begin to look at the fact that how do we protect ourselves against lithium chemtrails and fluoride and the autism shots that are given our children?
Exactly. We're getting hit by it. They're not going to hit us straight up military up front. That's for mopping up. And look, I know, because when bad people get elected and bad things happen, I psychoanalyzed myself years ago going to the shop, buying more guns and ammo, literally as like a comfort blanket. And so I'm not putting people down. I know I do it.
No, I'm not either. God knows I'm not doing that. But what I'm trying to say is...
I agree with you.
We need to start thinking about a better defense mechanism, because if they want to remove an entire community, let's say, for instance, they wanted a part of Georgia, the bordering Tennessee, that they wanted to just annihilate, they could do that in one fell swoop. I don't care how many weapons you got there. You can't shoot lithium out of the air. But purchase your weapons. Please do so. But
we're under attack by more ways than just guns.
Yeah, absolutely.
Talk about spiritual attack. More and more I realize we just got to go to God, hit our knees. In fact, I'm putting you on the spot. You didn't expect to do this, Pastor, but I really respect you and watch your TV show and also catch some of your sermons that are powerful there in Harlem, broadcast around the world. Will you lead us in prayer to maybe heal this nation or to protect Donald Trump or to have the people be knocked off their horses? Like Saul of Tarsus on his road to Damascus? Because, I mean, really, I think we have to ask God, don't we? I mean, is it that?
Oh, no. Absolutely. If you desire prayer, I certainly will pray.
Please do.
You want me to? Let's go to the Lord. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, we love you. We thank you. And we realize, Almighty God, we cannot win this election, take back America. We cannot be free without you. There was a time and the sentiments and the odor of when we could go to the election, pull the lever for a particular candidate, and it worked. Our vote was respected. But Jesus, we're fighting a much more deeper spiritual battle. We're fighting enemies that have powers over the airways. We're fighting an enemy who have power over the very foods that we eat. We need a word from heaven. We need your word, Almighty God, to be able to sustain us. We need your power, like you rained down fire from heaven with Elijah on the 850 prophets that were serving Jezebel and Ahab. We need the likeness of your power. We need, Almighty God, for you to touch the hearts of people who want to walk free, who want to walk in this beautiful nation. What a scream it is to see this beautiful nation ravaged by the people of the New World Order, who are destroying it by bringing in minorities and pushing out original founders and people who worked hard to make the trains run on time in this nation, to ravage it and to carve it up into various sections and pit people against one another. We need you, Almighty God, to work against the forces of Obama and all the people that he has under his foot and all the people that are in the grave as a result of him and of the Clintons. A large number of things can be said about politicians, and they all have their shortcomings. I'm not sure I'd ever want to be one, but one thing I do know, it is unmistakably clear that the Democrats have been charged with the actual silence and assassination and murdering of people that get in their political way. a lot more, even more so than we can ever begin to think about the Republicans. And I'm not for either one. They're both politicians. But Jesus, we need you. Let the American people turn to you. Yes, go to the rallies and support. But we need a word from the Lord. And let the preachers in the pulpits get up and start standing up and preaching your word again, not being afraid of the police or the CIA or Homeland Security or whosoever wants to come in. And let us all stand together. If they come at Alex, then let them know that they're going to have to come at all of America. We're coming down out of Oregon to support Alex. We're coming out of New Hampshire to support Alex. You will not be able to get in and out of a jailhouse if you arrest the voice that represent us. You won't be able to go home. We will surround the entire county with 100,000 deep of men who are standing saying, the hell, we're not going to take it anymore. What we are going to take is back our nation. Jesus, you can do that. You can rally us the way you did Gideon. You can rally us, Almighty God, the way you did David. You can rally our troops the way you did Joshua. And we're trusting that you do that. We pray that this prayer goes out all over the world, that men and women may know, but especially here in America, that we can stop all of this and we can salvage our nation in your name, Jesus. Not in our name, but in your name. And in your name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. And we see the persecution of Christians expanding. We see that there is an evil force behind the New World Order, Pastor Manning. If that force had its way, what would it do on this planet?
Well, what it primarily wants to do is to continue to call itself into the power of God. That's ultimately what they want to be able to do, Alex. They want to call themselves into the power of God.
Be omnipresent, control the weather, control society, control the words, play God.
Yeah, and they want to dumb down the American people, and they're using the media. And we need to talk more about the media. I'm going to have to go. You got to go. But we need to talk more about the media being a surrogate, if you will.
No, start getting into it, because they admit, when we have CNN admitting, we've done everything for Hillary we can. I mean, they just admit they're doing it. They admit they take orders. It's shameless now.
Yeah, but they want to use the media the way we ought to be using the church. They want to use the media to get people to actually bow down and worship whatever gods or politicians or ideologies that they put forward. They want the media to be, you don't have to go to church anymore. You can sit there in your easy chair, a lazy boy, and you can watch whatever you're watching on the media. If you're watching CNN, you're being led to believe a particular idea. They're talking about how their veracity is always on point. They're self-checking themselves, and then they bring in their own disciples, who they call commentators, to support the things that they're saying. And people are beginning to worship these people. They worship people at Apple. They worship the leaders of Google as if they worship these people. And so what they want to do is they really want to stand in the place of God, and don't nobody ever forget it. That's
well, there was an AP headline the other day asking, why are these tech company heads obsessed with eternal life? And they'll tell you, we're going to merge with machines and become God. We want to be God.
Absolutely. And they're looking for every possible way. You know, I watched the event of Steve Jobs and Apple. Who knows exactly what has happened with Steve Jobs? I know people call me conspiracy theorist.
They killed him for sure.
Hat wearer and all of these kinds of things they say about me. I brush it off. But I think what they're trying to do is to stop me when I've got something concrete to put to people, but I don't have the empirical evidence to make it work, to try to make me look silly. But I don't know what happened to Steve Jobs. I have no idea. I mean, we got Julian Assange over there in the Ecuador, if you will, embassy, who has been able to feed information and give a support system, and he has supported. We don't know where all these people are going or coming. We only get what the media tells us about them. Jobs still may be around looking to do something. I don't know. All I know is I don't believe the media. I don't believe what they tell me.
I hear you. They lie so much, we can't believe any of it. It's like Hillary a year and a half ago accused Trump of being an ISIS recruiter and saying he was their colonel or their sergeant. A recruiting sergeant was the exact term. Soros said that. Then he comes out and points out she's really funding it. And then, oh, how dare you? It's just, it's gotten so intense. I wonder what levels above this are going to be like. Have you seen the clip of the outgoing State Department spokesman last week saying, look, you know, we lie to the public and like laughing about it?
No, I don't think I've seen that clip. No, I don't. But I do know this, that the Clinton and Obama and others have been involved in the process of ISIS, involved in the process of creating an environment where ISIS thrives. Listen, there are a number of people who understand if they ever get in my gun sights, it's all over with. They know it. And if an organization, you got an organization that's rising with militancy around the world, and the president or the leader of the so-called free world or the so-called president does not put them in his gun sights, but lets them continue to roam around and to grow and gain power. I got to ask, why is that? You know, why does that happen?
Because they created it on record.
Yeah. So, I mean, we have to ask hard questions, and we can't, you know, one of the things I have to do on a daily basis, Alex, is I have to fortify myself against people calling me stupid for questioning these criminals in politics.
Absolutely. Being ridiculed means nothing to me, but seeing how dumbed down some people are really hurts me. Like a globalist sees some dumbed down person and says, oh, that's an opportunity to feed on this person. I just see a poor brainwashed person, and it makes me feel sick. Final segment with Pastor Manning, then your phone calls, breaking news, and more. Stay with us. I'm Alex Jones, your host. InfoWars.com is the website. Every day now I sit here, and it's like the Twilight Zone, like Matt Drudge said a few days ago, when the father of the guy that murdered all the people at the nightclub shows up in the VIP area about right behind Hillary in the Secret Service. And she's openly funding ISIS. She openly set it up and advocated for arming the rebels, who they knew who they were. She's involved in all this corruption. She's involved in the TPP. Now she says she was always against it, will be against it. And it just becomes ridiculous. I mean, I wonder where they're going to go next. Then we talk about her health problems. I mean, I do see it as biblical, like the plagues of Pharaoh, how unhealthy Bill looks, how unhealthy Hillary looks, the fact that they may be able to steal the election. I'm not saying that's going to happen, but even if they do get in there, what do you predict is going to happen once she's in there?
Well, there are a couple of things. Number one is that I think we need to be able to read the tea leaves more accurately. We need to focus on what I've seen very few people focus on, and that is the relationship between Tim Kaine and Hillary Clinton. Whether it's more than just a political relationship. And I'll leave it at that. But I got to tell you, we'll find a lot of answers if we go down that road of Tim Kaine and Hillary. Who are they, and why are they? Now, to try to respond to your question, you know, I was talking to someone the other day and said that if you want to find out what's going to happen in the future, watch the cartoons, because they put it in the cartoons. The globalist people put it in the cartoons first and see if it works. See if Mikey likes it. See if the kids like it. If the kids like it, then they go ahead and implement it. They find out that it works. It has a nice taste and a flavor to it. What I would say is that whatever your wildest imagination can happen in America in terms of turning it upside down. Right now, we've got more hatred, people, brother to brother, people to people, race to race. I mean, just the opposite of what they were touting to happen when they put that long-legged Mac Daddy Obama in the office. And we've got absolutely nothing done for the people for which he was elected to do, and everything to do for Wall Street, the bankers, and wealthy people worldwide, and for the Muslims. I mean, Muslims, they've been around for a very long time, but God knows that Obama has lifted them to a pinnacle right now where the Catholics, the Christians are minorities in comparison to the kind of press the media, the Muslims get. So to try to answer that question about Hillary, what is your wildest imagination of what she could possibly do and will do? Because she's going to want to outdo Obama, to be sure. That woman is wild.
She's foaming at the mouth to have war with Russia.
Yeah, she's wild. She's wild, Hillary. I mean, she's wild. And by the way, You know, Bill is not as bad as Hillary, even though he looks sick. He looks like he's dying. I don't know what he got him on, but he looks like he's getting ready to die tomorrow, first thing tomorrow morning. But she's a whole lot. It's Hillary, everybody, not Bill that you got to be afraid of.
Oh, she admittedly ran the show.
No, absolutely. She'd been running it for quite some time.
She's already been president for at least 8 years. That's a way to get around the term limit.
Yeah. Every time she has out little big glasses coming out of that scooter, she went up there and then someplace up there in the, up here in the Northeast. But yeah, I suspect that whatever your wildest imagination of what can possibly happen to this nation is going to happen if Hillary sits down in the Oval Office.
Because that's what they want. They want to mount our head on the wall. Thank you so much, Pastor Manning. It was always great to talk to you. Atla, ATLAH.org, ATLAH.org. God bless you. Talk to you soon. Have a great weekend.
God bless you as well, Alex. Take care. Thank you so very much for having me. Thank you.
We'll be back in 70 seconds with your phone calls. Wide open phones. Look at these headlines. They're up on Infowars.com. They're up on DrudgeReport.com, too. Poll, Clinton only up 1% against Trump. That's probably a more realistic poll, folks. Internal polling's been done. They're sampling 15 points ahead for Hillary in most of them. Trump's ahead. The problem is they're going to try to steal the battleground states. The fake polls are about convincing you that he really lost. That's why Trump gets that and is not going along with it. Just like, he's a sore loser, they wrote back in April. U.S. News and World Report and everywhere else, basically. He's not following the rules. So what if he won the popular vote, buddy? Meanwhile, Apple, Twitter, Google, Instagram collude to defeat Trump. Media and froth to take him down. CNN, we couldn't help Hillary any more than we are. And then we've got reports here with folks really getting upset and really getting angry. CNN feels the anti-media rage. Oh, yeah, it's time to put any type of heat you can possibly on outlets like CNN, MSNBC, especially if they're doing a live show in your town, your city. It's legal and lawful for you if they're out on the street doing a broadcast, whatever, to hit them with a bullhorn. By hit them, I mean blast them with audio. And that folks ask here in the office, they go, what do you think Drudge is playing this video for? Why is it the center video? It's just one guy saying, F you, you're traitors, you know, I'm a patriot to CNN. I think what Drudge is saying is this is how he feels. I'm not speaking for Drudge. I didn't talk to Drudge. But it's saying, this is how you should really respond to these people. We should shun them or get in their face and say, listen, you sent people here to blame Bernie Sanders and to blame Trump. Hillary did. You're dirtbags. You're criminals. But now we're getting in your face, okay? We're not playing along with you, just like I told Piers Morgan. Look, you want our guns. Stop acting like you want reasonable gun control, you piece of filth. You're a foreign agent here trying to get our guns. I want to go to Nick in California on the Green Party. I want to talk to Dean in Texas about trade deal, how they're rigged and more. And Doug in Arizona and many others. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. But I'm not going to go to calls now. I want to go to the next segment so I can give each caller plenty of time, but don't cut somebody short if I go to them now. And I've got some other clips. There's a lot of amazing clips that are really illustrative of what we're dealing with. The good news is more corruption on Hillary using the State Department and her foundation as a giant cash machine where you could buy influence internationally. That is all starting to come out. So more criminal investigations on that front. Hillary can run, but historically she can't hide. I personally have been very, very excited to see a lot of positive things happen in the last few weeks. But to really see the worst side of the mainstream media and to see how gleeful they are in their deception and their attack on the truth really sets the table for them to do anything you can imagine in the future. And it just is a sickening feeling to be proven totally right. In fact, I've been proven wrong. This is worse than I thought it would be at this time in the game. So it is just, I've always had a really good sixth sense. And it's been intensifying the last few years, but I have a feeling of sorrow, of loss, of really being frustrated. You know, there are a lot of New Agers and folks that are great people, but they think you're just positive all the time. That makes things positive. No, that's called being delusional. when you have to go in for surgery for a broken bone, or you have to lance a boil or cut out a wart or something, it doesn't feel good at the time, but it's good for you overall. And so I am here not dodging the legitimate suffering. I am here facing this garbage every day head on, because it's what I chose to do. We're making real headway against evil right now, but it's fighting back, and it is big stuff's already happening. Horrible stuff's already happening. Our government's murdering Christians by the hundreds of thousands. It's being done in our name. We're paying for it in places like Syria. And so I think what I really feel is God's wrath. I feel judgment coming down on the world. It is Friday, the 12th day of August 2016. I'm your host, Alex Jones. We're going to go to your calls right now. During the break, I was monitoring CNN out in the control room, and then I walked back into the coffee room and got a cup of tea, and Fox was on. And just as a media person, I could see how it's all scripted now by the same people. Fox was run by Roger Ailes to control the conservative movement, but he actually was a patriot. And so that spirit was there. But now it's basically almost fallen. They're now, you can just see in the month since Ailes has been out, of the 3 weeks, they're now already rapidly phasing it out. But they're going to do it quietly, strangling it in the dark so it's not too noticeable. And there'll still be tokenism, but they're getting ready for the big steal. But I wouldn't get demoralized by that, even if they steal this election. What we've done injecting truth, what we've done exposing globalism is irrevocable. But I was looking at the CNN anchors, and I just felt sorry for them. They're just given a talking point. They sit there and banner it back and forth. They create this wall of lies, like used to. They'd spin here, lie there, but they still had people's attention. So, you know, they had to be careful about things. But now they know they're caught, so just why not go all the way? It's mind-boggling. And I realize that I've gone from hating these people to just they're just pathetic. They really are pathetic. And then somebody like Hillary Clinton, she's like not even a human. She's just, you can look at her. You wouldn't invite that person over for Sunday brunch. You wouldn't go on a camping trip with them. You wouldn't be in a book club with them, or a chess club, or a car club, or a golf club, or a church. I mean, it's like a creature that just goes around wanting power and just lies and spins and deceives. I'll hand it to Rand Paul, Senator Paul. That's what made me love him. You know, his bold stance exposing that Hillary and Obama were funding ISIS in the Middle East. That's the senator I wanted to be president. Rand Paul, Hillary could get 5 years in prison for lying to Congress about weapons going to ISIS. And she lied and she sent them. And she testified that she didn't. And we've already known that she ordered it through the State Department import-export group. We've had the very whistleblowers on, and that's the testament to InfoWars. I know the system knows this, so that's why I'm going to talk about it, but we were huge 10 years ago. We were big 20 years ago. And not because I was that good, but because it was just everybody else was in a trance. I guess most people like read a couple spy novels and then they think they know about how clandestine stuff works. Instead of actually, as a citizen, going out and engaging in information warfare organically as an independent person, I then discovered how it really worked. And there's no one more depressed than people that aren't evil, that are in this system and then don't know how to get out of it. And who don't see an American people that are smart enough or involved enough for them to even be able to be involved. Because if they do get involved, they're just going to get laughed at by a bunch of people that look like they're trying to make a casting call for Idiocracy. In fact, I watched that clip again. What's his name? He was the outgoing head State Department spokesman. Name begins with a C. And he laughs and makes fun of everybody. And one of the reporters talks about lying and obfuscation and destroying democracy. And then he goes, yeah, can you tell it's my last day? And see, I'd only seen a shorter clip. When I watched the whole clip, the guy at the end, I watched it on C-SPAN, kind of just sits there and starts breathing heavy. And then like, okay. And then he takes more questions and kind of stumbles off. So I think that's actually someone freaking out. I mean, because this is crazy. You understand our government sent in over 200,000 jihadis with an express mission to kill every Christian they came across. They've killed over 200,000 Christians, 100,000 non-radical Muslims. They've displaced over 1 million real Syrians. And our government directed that. That's why they let 0.3% Christians in, even though they were like 25% of the Syrian population. They're now 20%. Look it up. If you're taking, and Obama goes, we got to be fair. That's why we're bringing in Muslims. They're not even bringing Sunnis in. I mean, they're not even bringing Shiites in. They're bringing Sunnis in. That's like 98% of what they're bringing in. And you, it's like, oh my gosh, they're resettling their jihad army that failed. Whoa, 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 whoa. I mean, you really want to get me. We're going to go to your calls, I promise. In fact, everybody holding gets a free Hillary for President shirt. In fact, John, go through, get their address. I'm sending everybody in size a free Hillary for President shirt just for holding for an hour. And throw in a bottle of silver bullet colloidal silver on top of this. 50% off right now, I should add. This is Mark Toner, former State Department. He quit last week.
Welcome to the State Department. I think we have some interns in the back. Welcome. Good to see you in this exercise and transparency and democracy.
Is that what it is?
Sorry,
I thought it was an exercise of, an exercise in spin and obfuscation.
All right. Can you tell us in my last briefing?
Now, they've got the new girl. This is from yesterday. The new girl's there, and this is them spinning and obfuscating now from the same lectern, covering up for Hillary and what the State Department has done. So let's play that clip, and we're going to Dean and Nick and William and Doug and Bob and others. Go ahead and play that clip.
Do you have any response to criticism by some that suggests there was a relationship between the Clinton Foundation and the State Department at the time? There was an email that came out in this recent set that is between an executive at the Clinton Foundation and Huma Abedin and Cheryl Mills, where he is requesting to set up a meeting between a billionaire donor and the U.S. ambassador to Lebanon. Do you have any response to?
So, you know, very similar to what I said before, I'm not going to speak to specific emails. However, I think you guys know State Department officials are regularly in touch with a wide variety of outside individuals and organizations, including businesses, nonprofits, NGOs, think tanks. You know, the nearly 55,000 pages of former Secretary Clinton's emails released by the department over the past year give a sense of the wide range of individuals, both inside and outside government, that State Department officials are in contact with on a range of subjects.
So you don't feel like this email or you don't feel like there was impropriety in the relationship between the Clinton Foundation and the State Department?
We talked to a wide range of people at my level, at various levels in the department.
This is Hillary with the foundation that she's getting money, and then the world leaders contact the State Department to be hooked up with it so that they'll take the weapons bans and other things off. This is her selling U.S. policy with her big fat butt hanging out in her face. This is like you come home and your neighbor is having sex with your wife on the hood of your car in front of the neighbors at a volleyball party. And you go, Bob, you're on my wife. No, I'm not, Bill. Yeah, you are. Hold on just a minute. And he finishes up in front of you and then stands there naked in front of you going, well, you're crazy, man. Nothing's going on here. And I hate to use a vulgar analogy, but that's what this is like. And this is the new pinhead they've rolled out. But you know what? The press goes along with this, so this is what you deserve. And when they take your pension funds and when the whole economy collapses and cities are burning, just remember Hillary's going to be on a private jet out of here, okay? Remember, you sold your country out because you thought it was cute. Here it is.
at various levels in the department, NGOs, think tanks, business leaders, you know, experts on a variety of subjects.
Except in this
her question.
And importantly, in this case, Secretary Clinton made a pledge that she would not personally or substantially in any way involve herself with the Clinton Foundation. So it's not just any outside organization, it's a specific organization that she said ahead of time she wouldn't have contact with. So doesn't this then seem to violate that pledge?
So again, to reiterate, you know, department officials are in touch with.
This is their pseudo-intellectual thing they do where they go, again, 2 plus 2 equals 9. No, ma'am, it equals 4. Again. We're so intellectual. Let's go back.
Again, to reiterate, you know, department officials are in touch with a wide range of individuals. I'd note that former Secretary Clinton's ethics agreement did not preclude other State Department officials from having contact with Clinton Foundation staff.
Okay. Can you at least try to answer Abigail's question, which was, has the department looked into this and determined that there was no impropriety?
The department is regularly in touch with people across the whole spectrum.
That's not the question. The question is whether or not you looked into the building has looked into it and determined that everything was okay, that there was nothing wrong.
We feel confident in our ability and our past practice of reaching out to a variety of sources and being responsive to requests.
I'm sorry, am I not speaking English? Is this, is it coming across as a form? I'm not asking you if, no one is saying it's not okay or it's bad.
Have you looked into it, dumbass?
A broad variety of input from different people. The question is whether or not you determined that there was nothing improper here.
We feel confident that all the rules were followed.
There you go. You're just under all these criminal investigations. More emails are coming out, and we're not looking into it. That's the answer. State Department not wiping its own rear end. And look, I get you're crapping all over us, but have the decency to not rub it in, lady. And look at this poor, soft, pinhead woman, lives in the Beltway, probably can't even, you know, cook dinner for her kids if she's got them. And she's just got 2 or 3 degrees as a political hack just thrown in here for the fall of America with some tottering, weird, psycho crone bragging about everybody that she kills. Only one other freak I know does that, and that's Obama. Well, I guess Richard Pearl. Richard Pearl waddles up at cocktail parties, this has been in the news, to the hottest woman in them, weighing like 350 pounds in a suit with huge black circles around his eyes, and then tells women, I order the wars that kill massive numbers of people. Richard Pearl, that's not what turns women on, jackass. I mean, again, it shows the total disconnect of these people. The total, complete disconnect. It's like Kim Jong-un thinks that having some bizarro Dennis Rodman basketball player there is cool, with his top generals clapping while they sit there and watch him play an exhibition game. I mean, it just shows we're ruled by the most aberrant, freakazoid, crazy people, because normal people don't want to tell people what to do. My kids might be a little spoiled sometimes because I don't want to run their lives. Shame, I just can't handle anymore. Why are we ruled by filth? What is going on in North Korea? What is that joke? What is that? What is that? What is Hitler? What is Stalin? What is Mao? What is all this stuff? What is Venezuela? Collapsing into hell. I can go to UT right now and half the students will be calling for communism, running around on their smartphones. Can't look at Hillary Clinton or Kim Jong-un anymore. Oh, the little eyes, the little power, little demon look, the little power. Oh, I have power. Oh, and then no one stands up to him. Richard Pearl drifting around, known as the Prince of Darkness, in a black suit with like little warts on his cheeks, sauntering over to a 30-year-old, you know, Washington Post reporter and going, you know I'm powerful. I command forces that kill people. They're like, ugh. But see, they know to recoil from it But the women don't recoil from that whole sickening culture itself. And that's what Drudge is saying with that video. CNN feels anti-media rage. I'm going to play the video coming up in the next segment. But it's just time to say, look, scum, you are filth, and we see you for what you are. All right, I'm going to your calls. William in Tennessee is on WBCR 1470. I'll go to him after I talk to Nick, who's listening on 1340 AM, KOMY at Santa Cruz. Dean and others, we're going to tell everybody. So thank you for holding. You're all getting your free Hillary for Prison shirt and free bottle of colloidal silver for me making you hold over an hour. I'm going to start doing that. Every time it's over an hour, John, it just kicks in. They get a free T-shirt or colloidal silver or basically whatever they want. It's just under $20 because I can't afford that. Let's go ahead and go to Nick. Nick, you're in California. Am I going to get good stuff in my stocking this year?
Hey, man, thank you. Well, I'm calling you.
Yes, sir.
A comment and two questions, and I'm just going to unload with them. It's politics that the Monterey County run as far as just reached top 10, Neon Peninsula territory. Question, router jackup. Email, Hillary's email, is it enough, loose enough to endanger Iranian nuclear scientists? And you're stalking. Well, let's talk about Greens. Nobody's doing it yet. Is that the surprise attack? We'll get him, I mean, Obama again?
Listen, I hear you, Nick. Yeah. The Green Party, the Libertarians, everybody should not vote for those ringers. I'm normally for third parties to grow them because you have two bad candidates usually. Everyone should be all in Trump. The entire power structure is against Trump. William in Tennessee, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, I want to talk about your alleged voter fraud. Out of a billion votes cast in 2000 on a Loyola study, 31 instances of irregularities. So,
and what's your source of that? Snopes?
Loyola University.
Okay, well, send it to me because, this country's famous for voter fraud. We have international watch groups. We go look at other elections. There's constant issues with elections. I have witnessed election fraud myself. When I was involved in elections following it, have had the state certify that was fraud, but still certify the election. These Diebold machines, their own engineers have said they've been ordered to hack stuff all over the country. I mean, just to say that there's only 30-something instances of election fraud. See, there's voter fraud and then election fraud, sir. You know the difference, right?
Voter fraud is infinitesimal in this country.
Okay, you don't even understand me. I understand. Look, I don't want to argue with you. It's probably just that we can't. Listen, I'm going to give you the floor for 60 seconds, but let me see if you understand this. Retail voter fraud is individuals engaged in double voting or dead people voting, okay? And then election fraud is organized at least the precinct or county level. Okay, I mean, do you understand what I'm saying, sir?
Yes, but it doesn't exist. But go right ahead.
You just said it doesn't exist, but go on ahead. You can go to the history of voter news services alone and then online encyclopedia and then look at the bibliographies of all the mainstream news articles where every election there's giant fraud and problems, so they always change their name. But you say election fraud, so Kennedy didn't steal Illinois and LBJ didn't get into Congress stealing, because that's admitted.
Oh, really?
Hold on just a minute. You know about Jim Crow laws and the huge move to suppress black votes in this country and poor sharecroppers' votes?
I'm talking about the current election cycle that you're referring to.
The current election cycle hasn't even... Wait a minute. We just saw them ignore the popular vote for Bernie Sanders and give it to Hillary Clinton. What planet are you living on?
Hamline University, School of Business, St. Paul, Minnesota. Professor David Schultz.
Oh, my gosh. Like they have a professor in Illinois that says the founding fathers were against guns. Of course, he lost his job. It wasn't true, but go ahead.
Okay, Alex, again, there is infinitesimal voter and election fraud in this country. There is no rigged election for Hillary. It's going to happen. Trump is lying. He's making it up. He's going to lose. There is no voter fraud. You cannot prove.
William, what do you do for a living? Are you a social worker?
If you can prove voter fraud, please.
Are you a social worker?
That's irrelevant. Please tell me if you can provide evidence of voter fraud. List for me proof and documentation, please.
Well, that's a classic non-debate tactic. We filed tons of reports this last week and this week on Infowars.com with video reports showing admissions of election fraud. Bev Harris, frequent guest, is coming on next week. Made Hacking Democracy that aired on HBO and won a bunch of awards. proving major fraud in Ohio. They certified national fraud that went on. I mean, this is ongoing, sir. You're like, I mean, you want me to prove there's a blue sky outside? Because it is blue sky in Austin. Now, in Japan, I think it's dark, nighttime, right? I mean, I don't have to prove
you cannot source your own website that they sourced.
No, it's not. I just said HBO. Have you heard of Home Box Office? Hold on. Have you heard of Home Box Office?
Yes.
Do you believe there's a documentary called Hacking Democracy?
A documentary is not proof of voter fraud. Can you give me evidence of voter fraud?
Sir, I can pull up for you right now congressional and state testimony by Diebold executives and chief engineers about organized fraud, elections that were stolen under orders and patches put on computers to steal elections, sir.
What are those links then?
Well, I mean, we've written news articles about it, but you're just hoping the audience is stupid and doesn't know about this. We've written articles with those links, with that information in there. And, I mean, is this your poor, pathetic attempt to try to imply that we shouldn't try to protect the integrity of our election system in this country? Are you denying that superdelegates took votes from Bernie Sanders?
Superdelegates do what they want to do, Alex. They're not bound to one candidate.
You think you're part of the power structure. I get it. You probably can't even tie your shoelaces. You notice that I said, are you a social worker? And he said, I'm not going to talk about what I do. About half the time I ask that question, they turn out to be social workers. And being on radio more than 20 years, you learn. And then back in the old days, we would actually get memos from the radio network I was on, Shamrock Communications before GCN, that, hey, look out for these seminar callers. And a lot of times, government social workers basically are given by their union talking points, phone numbers, and who to target. And they'll just say, you're lying, you're lying, you're lying. Fire engines aren't red. Fire engines aren't red. And it's just meant to create disbelief in people. And you have to remember, these social workers, and there's some nice social workers, I want to be clear, they're used to dealing with mentally retarded people, really old folks, criminals, abused children, you name it. So there's a kind of an elitism to it. You see, everybody's an idiot but them. And I tell you what I'm going to do just for that caller. I'm going to take that call. And then I'm going to create about a 10-minute video with, I don't know, Josh Owen, Zimmerman, whoever wants to do it. Just somebody tell me you're going to do it, or I'll assign it. Because the crew's always, you know, chomping the bit to do stuff. And we're just going to take clips of congressional testimony and state testimony and Diebold executives and hackers hacking into elections and CBS News admitting it's a problem and then election fraud and illegals voting and dead people getting Social Security and dead people getting IRS tax returns. I mean, James O'Keefe of Project Veritas went in and voted as M&M recently. All these battleground states basically have changed laws where anybody can vote. In fact, I'm not stupid, because if I did it, they'll arrest me. I could go vote repeatedly in Travis County. But I'm not going to do it. And you just heard a caller, that I'm going back to your calls, who literally just said, there's a Loyola University thing. We pulled it up. That was totally shot down. The professor did a little study and said he couldn't find a bunch of examples. Well, my God, that's like saying, I walked out in my backyard and, you know, I couldn't find a Tyrannosaurus Rex skull, so maybe no fossils have ever been found. And let's scroll back up. I mean, love the fake, ironic, purple glasses of Chris Hedges. That's that MSNBC host name, right? You know, this whole, that's Rachel Maddow's, yeah, okay. Voter fraud deniers resurfaced just in time for midterm elections. I mean, we've got California and Illinois and Oregon and Vermont introducing legislation that last time I heard Illinois passed and was on the governor's desk. Did that pass? Legalizing illegals voting? So we're going to take all those clips and put it to that seminar caller. And I bet that seminar caller is just reeling. How would I know he's a social worker? How would I? Because I'm smart, dumbass, unlike you. I don't think I'm part of the establishment. I don't want to go rule over a bunch of old people and retarded children like you do. Okay? So, I know you. I know you of old. There you go. But you really ought to be ashamed of yourself. My audience consists of common folks, right up to rocket scientists and foreign leaders. But you know what? The most common person is better, even if they're not that smart on average, because their heart loves God and loves justice. But you know you were lying, implying there's no election fraud or no voter fraud. That was ridiculous. Now, here's James O'Keefe's piece. Let's put the article up on screen for TV viewers so I can list it for radio listeners if they want to go see the video at Project Veritas website. We should probably repost this to Project Veritas. James O'Keefe obtains Eminem's ballot. Now, get ready. He's coming in to get Eminem's ballot where they have a record of it so he can go be Eminem. He's stealing his identity right here on television for you right now.
Hi, my name is
polling station, Clemson Township.
On your ID doesn't matter, so I walked into the school claiming the martial matters. Black hoodie, black hat, I gave his address. How easy was it?
Hello. My name is Marshall Bruce Mathers.
Okay, you just have to fill out an application first, and then we'll need a picture of your driver's license.
Oh, you know what? I don't have a driver's license with me.
Do you have any other picture ID?
I don't. I left. I came from work, and I don't have my wallet. But the name is Marshall Mathers.
You can stop the back of this.
Okay.
Yeah, you stop to fill this out. And then you'll sign in on our band. You can still vote.
So I can still vote?
Backside. Yes.
Yep.
Fill this backside.
All I got to do is fill this out.
Yeah.
That's right. You can go into Travis County and say, Alex Jones, I guess, and vote.
Yeah, and then you fill out an
A. But I don't have a driver's license.
That's all right.
You're forming.
Yeah.
That's why you're signing that.
Yeah. Your driver's license. Just make up any name you want.
Then you have to fill out your information with your name.
Bob Jones, Keebler Elf.
My middle name is Bruce, and I have a suffix, the third. Or if that is the middle name, I could just Marshall Bruce Mathers, the third.
Yeah. They'll find you.
They'll find you in there.
Well, why don't you have to fill it out?
Okay, you'll look it up.
Yeah.
All right. The last name is Mathers, M-A-T-H-E-R-S. First name is Marshall.
Yep, that's what it says.
So you guys will let me vote. Marshall Bruce Mathers, all I got to do is sign this thing here.
Yeah, you got to fill both sides.
Fill both things out.
Can you confirm your birthday with us?
The birthday is October 17th,
1972.
Yep. That's a great thing there. I mean, you know, I was worried. I didn't have my ID. What's that?
You have a really nice name.
Oh.
Are you related to a certain somebody named Marshall Mathers?
Oh, everyone always says that, but, you know, it's...
I don't even know he's on the number, right?
Yeah.
He lives in the area.
Well, that last caller really asked for it. We're going to hit him hard.
Okay. You know, I have a phone call. I'll be right back. Just give me 1 second. Yo, Shug. Yeah, I'm voting right now. Yeah, I know we gotta squash that beef, but I'm voting right now. Yeah, I know. I thought I needed an ID too, but they don't need it. All right, I gotta go. That kills me.
All right, that's ProjectVeritas.com. Now, I'm going to go back to your calls. I'm not going to let that guy that was disagreeing dominate everything. But, I mean, that's what I mean. He's just slithering around lying, knowing he was lying. Just go to Google, even though they game a lot of this, and just type in voter fraud or election fraud or engineer testifies on election fraud. I mean, it's just there's literally hundreds of news articles, hundreds of videos. Quite frankly, a few weeks ago, I started pushing the initiative to expose all this, as you've noticed nationally, Trump talking about it as well. And I started watching the videos and reading the articles, and I thought I knew all of it. There was so much stuff, I couldn't even keep track of it. Bloomberg, how to hack an election. All the fraud in Latin America. I'll tell you this, at least you talk to the average Latin American. Of course there's election fraud. Only weirdo Democrats would sit there and deny it. Here's a little newsflash for you. Al Gore won the 2000 election. Al Gore. I hate Al Gore. But there was fraud. And Stone was the number two guy under James Baker running that recount. Number two. And he's apologized for it and said it was wrong, and he's very ashamed of it. He changed course 2 years after with the Iraq War and went public. That's why I like Stone. He's a real deal. I should have Stone on to tell us about election fraud. I did in the first hour. But, I mean, this is the type of crap I deal with all day long because they know they're lying, but it's like CNN anchors. They get up there and they pretend and all convince themselves and then think because they call in and tell us the sky isn't blue. And I love that tactic. Prove to me a blue whale exists. Show me one now. I'm like, dude, election fraud and voter fraud is well known. It's like saying, show me the blue sky. It's right above me, but I don't have to show it to you. It's like, prove to me that Abraham Lincoln was the Republican president born in Illinois. Prove to me the Civil War happened and Robert E. Lee existed. Prove to me there was ever a Second Amendment. Prove to me there was ever a First Amendment. Prove to me. Prove to me.
Hey, Alex.
Yes, yes, Matt. I wanted you to pop in. Go ahead.
You said that, you know, he must have been a Democrat because he doesn't believe in voter fraud. But I bet if Trump wins, all the Democrats are going to come out the woodwork just saying, hey, it had to have been election fraud, had to have been voter fraud.
I agree. Do we have any shortage of proof of election or voter fraud, Matt? I mean, we could spend 10 hours on it.
Arbin has close to 20 videos of election fraud, and that's in the past 2 months.
What did you make of his call, though?
It's not the first time I haven't heard something like that. I actually have gone back and forth with one of my old roommates about election fraud, and he actually kind of came at it from the same angle because it's not very widely reported on in the mainstream. And actually, before I started...
Yeah, because they've made the law where you just walk in and take over somebody's identity and vote.
Oh, yeah. And, you know, it was shocking for me. Once we started digging into it, just a little bit of searching on the internet will uncover all these instances where people are just going nuts. And the reason why I recommended that James O'Keefe video is just how blatant, how easy it is to go in and commit voter fraud. It's hilarious.
Well, other points on this. I mean, do you like my idea of taking that call and then just chopping it full of news articles and video clips?
Oh, yeah. No, that right there would be a powerful thing to share with everybody because there are people who don't believe it out there. That's kind of the sad truth. You know, people just don't believe because, you know what, again, they're people who are good-minded people. They wouldn't think to go do that
themselves. I agree those exist, Matt, but with this guy, the Democrats are the kings of retail low-level fraud. And yeah. So they are always, every year, every election year, they run around and say it doesn't exist.
You got to think like a criminal. That's the thing.
But wait
a
minute.
Think like a criminal.
Rachel Maddow wears purple glasses. Doesn't that mean like she's smarter than us?
She just, I can't help it. I love that sweater. I just want to snuggle up with her and drink a nice
Well, listen, I'm not normally gay, but I'm going to be honest. There's two people I'm gay for. There's two men I'm attracted to. And that is Donald Trump and Rachel Maddow. He's hot.
Stop
Rachel,
it.
I want a date.
Stop it. I can't
right,
stand
I'm joking
up now.
On both. I'm joking on both, obviously. Oh, my gosh. I'm gay for Marilyn Monroe. But, I mean, it just gets too ridiculous. The big list of vote fraud reports, WorldNet Daily, 108% of voting population endorses Obama. Remember that one? That was a good one. Remember that one? How about 8 million more people voted in 2012, but Romney got less votes than John McCain did in 2008? Does anyone believe that? Do you believe that? Anybody else in the control room want to pop in? Matt? Zach? Anybody else? I think we're good. How about Nico? Nico wants to pop in now. That means Nico doesn't want to come on air, the lead producer. We're going to make Nico Acosta come on the air right now.
This is CJ. I have a comment.
Okay.
The caller doesn't listen because if you recall, Texas primaries 2016, we had over 12 people call local AM and claim that they had voted for Trump, got to review, and they had apparently voted for Rubio.
Oh, yeah. There's major because they didn't want Texas to go for Trump. It's amazing. All right. Well, look. The caller's right, okay? I'm going to tell you, caller, you're right. You devastated us through intellectual prowess. I mean, brute force, 700 horsepower dominance. I'm like a lawnmower compared to your intellect. You crushed me. You're right. There's no voter fraud. There's no election fraud. I'm going to go home tonight and crawl in bed, and I'm going to get my pillow, and I'm going to get in a fetal position, and I'm going to cry for my mommy.
Then they'll send a social worker to your house.
Oh, no, no, I mean, I'm joking. I'm not actually depressed. That was a joke. I'll never commit suicide.
Hey, what? One last thing here, sure, about the election fraud. And that is one thing that we haven't touched on in terms of the electronic forms of voter fraud.
Yes.
We don't talk about it enough, but it's weighting the votes. So you have 10 people vote each side, right? But the side that votes the way that people who are rigging against, their votes are weighted to be 7/8 of a vote or 1/2.
Yeah, they shave it. I mean, we've got hundreds of documented cases where the engineers have gone public and then died in a car wreck the next week or in an airplane accident or shot in the back of the head.
Exactly. And that's actually the more likely way that it happens. Exactly. Yeah, that electronic form where you've got a vote that is.
And then there's no way to even track it because it was all a digital algorithm.
Yeah, yeah. And it would be much more feasible, much easier to get away with, right?
Well, I mean, look, I don't believe there's any corruption going on by this government. I mean, they would never lie to us, even though they get caught every day doing it. All right, good points there, Matt. Let's go to Dean in Tejas. Been holding a long time. Dean, welcome to the airwaves, sir.
Hey, it's great to be on. I've seen you all the way back to the Access days.
What'd you make of that last caller saying that we're making stuff up?
Well, I used to work at Dell Computer, and when they all went to computerized methods of taking the vote, there were articles about that showing how unbelievably vulnerable those are to all kinds of abuse, where you could get massive counts of votes in certain, let's say, counties or whatever that are responsible for doing the voting. I mean, they're unbelievably vulnerable. Canada, I read an article way back then about how they, they count the votes on paper ballots, and they have a witness from the sides of the opponents of the political process, and they count them up, and they complete the election in just a few hours or less. And,
we should go back to paper ballots and then have them be stored for like 5 years under law.
And the point is to have witnesses on all opposing sides to watch.
And those are real elections. Absolutely. That's exactly what we need. But LBJ still cheated with that system and had one key county. More people, voted than lived in the county. And that's how he got it over. And then those ballots got burned. You know, that old story.
Yeah, yeah. You can go back and recount, and it can be challenged, and there's no gamesmanship. I mean, my God, with the hacking of Hillary Clinton, and it's unbelievable. I mean, I have been hacked myself by a terrorist.
I have, too. I've had also everybody's had their identity messed with, and they're saying basically it exists for us individually, but not in an election. Does that hold water, Dean?
Yeah. Anyway, I want to get on to a point about Brexit, because that's mind-blowing. It'll kind of blow everybody's mind when I get to that. But I wanted to get, because we're always limited on time, I don't know how much more you'll give me, but on the rigged trade versus fair trade, this is an idea I had, and I wonder why it has never been caught on. I mean, I go all the way back. I was a Perot supporter. I remember the debates on NAFTA. I'm a sort of a C-SPAN junkie. I mean, I've been able to vote since 76. So, I've been following this stuff a long time. But he told us we were going to get rigged trade, and that's exactly what we got. And we know Clinton supported NAFTA, and it got voted in. Others have supported, and Hillary.
All right, so let me hear your idea when we come back. But absolutely. We played it in the first hour, if you missed it, folks. Maybe it was the second hour. Hillary saying that it was the first hour. Hillary saying that, she loves the TPP and helped author it and is the honcho of it and is the gold standard. And now she says she never said that and she will never did support it, won't support it now, and won't in the future. There's an amazing new graphic by the amazing Ben Garrison, who I want to get back on the broadcast. Only had him on like 30 minutes once. What an incredible talk show host in his own right. Even though he's not a talk show host, he did really great on air, but he's a famous editorial cartoonist, one of the most famous alive today, who didn't used to really be kind of an anti-globalist, at least started trying to censor him. He's got a new one out, Weekend at Hillary's, instead of Weekend at Bernie's. And it's got the Secret Service there with their tranquilizer dart and to keep her under control, stronger together. I don't feel no ways tired. And I always knew, looking at Ben Garrison cartoons, that a lot of them were influenced by the show, and that one certainly is. So I'm very, very honored. I want to get him back on the broadcast. But there's another James O'Keefe video where he goes in and votes as the most famous writer in the town for the newspaper. And they let him vote because you got the name, baby. We don't need driver's license in these Democrat-run states. And it's just hilarious to go fly on an airplane and watch illegals not even have IDs and be allowed to fly. I'm not against them, but I'm being screwed over. I don't want to be discriminated against. And it's a joke. And Hillary is in so much trouble. I'll be back this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. Central. I always say Lord willing because, you know, cross my fingers, knock on wood, and thank everybody for their prayers and the lucky stars. But a lot is going on in this world right now. This is a wild time. And obviously, you see me filing reports on Saturday and Sundays now on top of the Sunday show because I'm even putting a studio in at my house where I'm just going to start randomly just going live on all our platforms whenever I want. And then they're setting it up for somebody who's not too technical like myself. I'm actually very technical if I had to take time to figure stuff out, but I'm too busy. Where I'm just going to hit like one red button and I'm live on air, video cameras, you name it. So be looking for that. Talk about reality TV. We're actually talking about mounting cameras in certain offices of this company. So when we go in those offices, we hit live and folks see the behind the scenes war game because that's where the really interesting stuff goes on around here. Now sometimes we'll have like a button we hit to shut down info if it's a source or something. But I mean, it's just, I want folks to know what's going on at InfoWars. It really takes to the next level because real reality TV is fake. So we're going to have the real reality TV. Dean in Texas, go ahead and make your point about the Brexit and about trade and all these deals.
Thanks, Alex, for giving me the time on this. I think it's just it's the most critical thing in the world right now for everybody.
I understand. You got 2.5 minutes. No more preface. Go ahead.
Okay. All right. So anyway, we've been running these huge hundreds of billions of dollar deficits with NAFTA and then also with China. And these trade deals have been rigged for foreign governments' benefits. And they've become vastly wealthy. And we've been depleted. Whole communities, cities, regions of the United States. And this doesn't just involve the Rust Belt. This involves high-tech companies like Microsoft, Dell, or Time Warner Cable.
This is how they conquer us. They sell us out to foreign interests.
Yeah, they sent those tech support things over to India. You get terrible connections on the phone. They barely speak English. So this goes beyond just, you know, factory work. It is technical knowledge work too that's been exported away. And here's why it's rigged and why it's just been really like a crime to the American people. And this is where Trump hits the nail on the head on it. All we ever had to do with every trade deal was put in there that we would have a running average between the trade deficits and the trade surpluses between our countries that we had the trade deals with, and then this running
average. And then that's when the tariff kicks in, when they start screwing us. Absolutely.
Either that or have it more pro-growth where they buy what our deficit is. So when we run the billions in, let's say, in 5 years, they...
Then they got to buy our bonds, which gives them a stake in us and us in them. That's real globalism. In fact, that's how they sold globalism, but they never did that.
Or they buy our goods, you know, so that the manufacturing...
No, that's how they sold globalism to build up the world. That's how they got all the liberals on board in the 50s for the world government plan, bigger than the Manhattan Project. You just hit the nail on the head. That was actually their plan, brother. You just thought of it on your own. They just never implemented that. They did it as a one-sided deal to transfer power to these third world cesspools so they could control everybody. We'll be back. Stay with us. Well, you want to see the frontmen they've got. New York Times article, Fox News names two insiders to top post. But who's really running the show now is the Democratic Party and Hillary Clinton. They're giving the marching orders. And Bill Shein and Jack Abernathy load the teleprompters. And their job is to slowly strangle News Corp in its crib. I want to go back to your phone calls. And then in the next segment, I'm going to play a little piece. I'm told there's hours of this, but where I was talking about Hillary being the founder of ISIS, Hillary being the commander of ISIS, and then Trump saying it. We'll play a few of those clips and hand the baton to David Knight, who's in the other studio. Right now, let's go to Doug in Arizona. Doug, thanks for calling.
Hey, Alex. I've got two talking points. I hope I can catch them both as quickly as possible. I'll get them out. The first one is you wrote a story about mainstream media saying the elections were rigged. And it's the first time I've heard this, too. You remember, you did this just a little while ago, right?
I'm trying to understand you. We've run tens of thousands of stories a year, but I mean, I did run a story with CBS admitting that there's election fraud. We said, good job, CBS. You know, you're talking about the first
right,
hour
exactly.
today? Yeah.
And I had an epiphany after that. I said, hey, this is like a 180. Why are they going in this direction? What's the true meaning behind it? And I think it's if Trump wins the election, then they can say it was rigged and possibly cause enough scandal to postpone the elections, and then Obama can stay in power.
Sure. Well, I don't say that I think Trump's really winning just because I want to say that. I mean, they changed the methodology. He was 10 to 14 points ahead. Suddenly he's that far behind. They changed the methodology. They're rigging everything else. They admit they're rigging everything. I can't find Hillary supporters. I mean, it's like finding unicorns. And so I'm just saying, I really think there's a closeted group going for Trump, 10 points or so. And so I think he's going to win big time. Stone thinks he's going to win by a very narrow margin. I don't know. I mean, we're going to find out. All I know is this is a wild time to be alive. I mean, I'm so excited, I'm exhausted. I mean, this is a nail biter.
If he wins too big, though, this is where that scenario of election fraud can come in and using it in their spin, in their favor. Anyway, so that was the first talking point. Second talking point is I think we need to take a better look at Tim Kaine. Let's say Hillary does make it. I mean, come on, she's a corpse. She might make it 6 months. They're going to sacrifice the queen for the new King Kaine. That's why he's there.
Well, I'll say this. I mean, Kaine's a globalist. I've looked at his record. He's better than Hillary. I mean, he claims he's pro, you know, life, but then stands down. That's better than being openly, you know, pushing it like it's great. He's been quasi, you know, he's bad. He's like a rabid dog. She's like a rabid hyena.
Well, you know, he went to an all-boys Jesuit prep school. He's been a Jesuit missionary. He's a Harvard Law graduate.
Oh, well, that's not good because, you know, the Jesuits are making their move. Hell, they took over the Catholic Church and have got that new pope. That's just crazy. I've always stayed out of Catholic bashing because Catholics I meet are great people on the ground. But, man, this new pope's like, it's like having Mao Zedong as the pope. I mean, how much crazier is this going to get? What do you think, Doug?
I didn't catch you. What was that, Al?
I mean, how bad's it going to get with this pope?
That's another whole story that's going to play out.
Well, let me ask you this. I mean, are you running into any Hillary supporters in Arizona? Because I hear he's going to lose Arizona. That's the biggest load of baloney I ever heard.
You know, I hate to say it, but it seems like most of the Hillary supporters are the elderly.
Yeah, that's it. They just think she's going to give them a bigger sugar tit. All right, good to hear from you, Doug. We're going to talk to Bob, Terry, Debbie, Daniel, and others. Finish up with this clip and a lot more. David Knight's going to come in as a fresh horse. I am burning inside when it comes to fighting these people. David Knight's taking over. He's got so much to cover here in a few minutes. We've got proxy war shows. Who founded ISIS? New York Times admits it. Private property is in deep trouble. Immigration responses to what's happening with immigration. Voters won't believe it if Hillary wins. We've got so much coming up with David Knight. I've got a short compilation clip of where I'm talking about 3 years ago, 2 years ago, a year ago, Hillary being the commander of ISIS, the founder of ISIS. People really picked up on this. That, what is it like? You say something and Trump starts saying it. Well, yeah, we are one of the research places that Trump goes to. But the media will go, oh, see? The kooky thing that Hillary founded ISIS comes from Jones. No, it came from all the Pentagon sources and General Flynn through Colonel Schaefer and others 1 week after Benghazi. So you go pretend you're a journalist and all the rest of it, okay, and you go play in the little sandbox over there. We'll be in the big boy area, the big girl area. Someday you'll be in the short pants and one day the big long pants. But, I mean, it's just a joke. You people are a joke, okay? You're a joke. You think you should go to some big glitzy building and they got a teleprompter for you that you've arrived. You're a joke. You have no honor. But before I get to that clip, there's a clip we haven't played yet, and some people said, why is Drudge showing one guy flipping off CNN going, F you, I'm a patriot, you're a traitor. Well, that's a message from Drudge. This is how I feel to CNN, F you. I haven't talked to Drudge, but I'm telling you, Drudge is saying we should be done putting up with the Communist News Network, the Clinton News Network, spewing this info. Don't play along with them. I don't even go on CNN when they call me. They don't even call me anymore. I have one question. Is it live? And then they lie and go, yes, it's live. And then like 10 minutes before I get to the satellite place, they'll go, actually, it's taped now, Mr. Jones. So now I don't even call them back. I'm like, you don't want to go on CNN? You don't want to go on it? No, I don't want to go on you. It's like Fox when they had some, quote, executive a few years ago go, Jones tried to get a show at Fox but failed. He wants show business, but show business doesn't want him. And I'm like, what liars? I've turned down multiple show offers from you jackasses. A man called Mueller's witnessed it and couldn't believe it one time. There was another show I was offered. I even had him like, I'm like, okay, I want first class every time I fly to New York. And I want a first class hotel. They go, we don't give that to anybody. I go, oh, why am I doing it then? Okay, we'll give you that. Then we're getting madder and madder. And it's not that I even want first class. I'm pissing on them. Do you understand that? Before I say no. But now, I don't even play games with them now, okay? Because it's my religion to let them know they're nobodies. They want us to think we're nobodies? No, they're nobodies. They're the bullies. They're the trash. We've got this whole Fox News situation where they're installing all these people closer to Hillary that'll do whatever Murdoch and his sons want. That's being announced. So, but you can already see it. I mean, they are turning Fox News off, but slowly, kind of like the HAL 9000 in Space Odyssey. Captain, that's not needed for you to do. Why don't you just relax? No, oh, those are my main centers. Please, let's discuss this, please. No, and an hour later, I am a HAL 9000 created in Chicago, Illinois. Dr. Such and Such, my first teacher, taught me this song. Daisy, Daisy, give me your I'm afraid, Dave. I'm afraid.
Bye-bye. They make $1 billion a year off of it. That's nothing to the hundreds of millions News Corp makes, and they're going to get a big juicy slice of all the other state-sponsored propaganda pie. Tens of billions a year is already given to News Corp, the big dirty secret we're going to be revealing very soon, of government taxpayer money.
So, what does this signify? It's time to tell the mainstream media, go straight to hell. Here's the clip. That was very dramatic. Some third world tyranny or Eastern Europe or something, and he's freaking pissed. He understands how this country's going to go straight to hell now. See, you should take it personal, too. We're in a death battle, people.
Patriot! American patriot!
All right, let's go ahead and play this clip of who the real founder of ISIS is. And I love how it clicked this morning because McBrain's like, is this the clip you're looking for where you said she's the commander of it? Or the founder of it? Because we found plenty of me saying she's the commander, the leader. I've said she's the founder. We finally are finding some of those. But just to show, folks, trailblazing that's happening here, to show the power you can have as well, taking action. And McBrain's like, is this it? He's playing one where I'd forgotten Hillary a year and a half ago with Soros said he's the number one recruiting sergeant. He's the leader of ISIS. Because they knew Trump was going to go with that later. So it's okay when she says he's the founder of it or the commander of it or the recruiter for it because there's no reality in that. Though that was perfectly fine. But when he does it because it's true, then it's the end of the world. Let's go ahead and play those clips. They blew up all the infrastructure, turned Al-Qaeda loose to run around murdering everybody. Now Al-Qaeda has spilt all the way into Central Africa, all the way into Western Africa, and is just running around murdering everyone. All run by Hillary Clinton.
We let ISIS take this position. It was Hillary Clinton that she should get an award from them as the founder of ISIS. That's what it...
ABC's cut out right there. And they are now moving forward, rolling forward with massive censorship. She gets up there and she says, you know, ISIS is using Donald Trump videos to recruit.
He is becoming ISIS's best recruiter.
I mean, you heard the CIA whistleblowers like Tosh Plumlee. He had to retire when he came on this show. You heard them all say that she's running through the State Department a program with billions of dollars back to her foundation to send money out to all these different groups, and then the money just comes right back to her. They give them the weapons, they send her money back. But because the other agencies wouldn't go along with it, they had to kill the people at that base and kill the ambassador to cover it up.
ISIS is honoring President Obama. He is the founder of ISIS. He's the founder of ISIS.
When the Soviet Union invaded Afghanistan, we had this brilliant idea that we were going to come to Pakistan and create a force of Mujahideen, equip them with Stinger missiles and everything else to go after the Soviets inside Afghanistan. And we were successful.
I would say the co-founder would be crooked Hillary Clinton.
This can't really be happening, that Hillary Clinton's probably going to be our next president, when she's such a criminal gangster, so evil, such a fraud, and armed Al-Qaeda and ran the whole strategy to destabilize Africa and the Middle East.
The people we are fighting today, we funded 20 years ago.
What's crazy is she goes back to the fact that Jimmy Carter and then Reagan did that before they knew about any of the blowback or any of this. It's been since Clinton, right through to now with Bush and her radicalizing it with Saudi Arabia in this new deal. And I'm not defending what Reagan or others did. The point is that he always gets the blame when really it was Zbigniew Brzezinski that had the larger plan and wrote a book about it called The Grand Chessboard, which I've read three times. And I have to have these, again, pseudo-debates with idiots that don't read books by Zbigniew Brzezinski. And I'm not up here on some pedestal, but if you want to debate me, did you read The Technotronic Era, Between Two Ages, Tragedy and Hope, The Anglo-American Establishment? Some of those are books written by the fellow that wrote Tragedy and Hope and other key books. I mean, I know their mindset. I know who they are, and you don't. But now Hillary's taken that same strategy and done this and turned them loose all over, and then they brought 5 million into Europe. What is that for? To hold Europe hostage. All right, we're going to throw this to break, come back with David Knight. Briefly, I didn't even plug last hour. If you want to see more reporters, if you want to see more writers, if you want to see us even more effective in putting out the true narrative and defeating the globalist, and quite frankly, risking our lives in a very exciting way, I just love it, quite frankly. When I'm exhausted and stuff, I think about how dangerous this is, and that's when I actually feel good about it. People say, God, you got courage. Once you're scared, I'm like, hey, man, it's how epic this is that gives me the energy. No, I'm not scared. I'm scared they're going to win. I'm not scared about me. And I'm telling you, folks, we've got 50% off colloidal silver right now, Silver Bullet. We got a bunch of other specials, 23% off the power packs that recharge your car and all these little plugs and things. It's really a great technology. 33% off the solar panel bases and solar panels, great systems. We've got, if you're looking for the right solar panel systems, this is it from our research. And it's $1,000 off right now. It's even more than $1,000 off. Holy Toledo. So that's all available at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139, 888-253-3139. And there's a lot of other specials up there on the site as well, but it is important to be self-sufficient. I spend 70% of my time trying to change and fix things. I spend 30% now getting ready. I just spend about 5% of my time doing it. So get prepared, get ready, get great high-quality products at InfoWarsStore.com and support the broadcast. That way you can be on the offense and the defense right there with a purchase. It's a perfect equation. Stay with us.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host in this fourth hour on this Friday, August 12, 2016. I'm going to pick up where Alex left off. He ran that clip talking about, yeah, Hillary Clinton and Obama really are the founders of ISIS. You have to understand that. I just find it absolutely amazing that we now see CNN and other outlets coming out and saying, Hillary doesn't want to control the guns. We didn't have anything to do with the creation of ISIS, the training or equipping of ISIS. At the same time, that the New York Times, this is going back to August 6th, so this is essentially, less than a week ago, New York Times said, military success in Syria gives Putin the upper hand in the U.S. proxy war. Yeah, just report on this the beginning of the week on the nightly news. They're calling it a proxy war. They're saying Russia is beating America in Syria in a proxy war. Okay, so who's on the two sides? Who are the players? Who's our proxy? Well, on the Russian side, the proxy is Syria and Assad, okay? Who is on our side? The New York Times says it's Al-Qaeda, ISIS, Al-Nusra, the rebels. Let me read you a little bit of this. The Syrian military, they said, was floundering last year. The rebel offensive was aided by powerful tank-destroying missiles supplied by the CIA and Saudi Arabia. But then the Russians arrived, and they bludgeoned CIA-backed rebel forces for the first time since Afghanistan in the 1980s. Okay, and that would be, as Alex just pointed out, what Zbigniew Brzezinski and Jimmy Carter, his assistant Jimmy Carter, created with the Mujahideen to go after the Russians in Afghanistan. And then we continued that under Reagan because, you know, the foreign policy of the elites at the top, the globalist warmongers, are the same, whether it's Republican or Democrat. It really doesn't matter. That's why they hate Donald Trump so much. And that's why you've got these 50 globalist spooks signing a letter saying that Donald Trump isn't fit to be president. Okay? Why? Because he is openly saying the stuff that they don't want you to know. He's exposing their lies, their corruption, their chaos, their being on both sides of most conflicts, but especially being on the side of the terrorists and telling us that they're going to protect us from the terrorists, both abroad and domestically. They create the threat, and then they have their solution, which is more government, more military, more police, more force directed at us, not at them. Okay, they're telling you that they're fighting ISIS. They're not fighting ISIS. The New York Times is telling you at the same time, this is a proxy war that we're losing, and the people on our side are ISIS. They go on to say, we've now, for the first time since the 1980s, the Russian military for the past year has been in direct combat with rebel forces trained and supplied by the CIA. Okay, that's that conspiracy theory website, the New York Times, that liberals think is the paper of record. If you think that is the paper of record, then listen to them because they have recorded what's going on. And they're telling you, they'll tell you on a Saturday or whatever what's going on. But then throughout the week, they pretend it doesn't exist, just like CNN wants to pretend that Hillary Clinton has never said anything about taking your guns, okay? Okay, CNN says that you've got various, you got the Washington Post writing an op-ed post saying, Hillary Clinton's not for gun control, get serious. Okay, yeah, we're going to talk about that in a moment, too. They go on to say, even quoting a guy from the Woodrow Wilson Center, Russia has won the proxy war, at least for now, said Michael Kaufman, a fellow at the Woodrow Wilson Center in Washington. Woodrow Wilson, another globalist, okay? And as we pointed out, and we talked about it at the time, where did all this start, okay? Libya is the arms bazaar for chaos, especially for ISIS, for all these terrorists. That's where they're getting their weapons. That's where this all began. Why did that happen? Why do we have to overthrow the Syrian government? Why did we have to overthrow Libya? Well, we know now because WikiLeaks gave us Hillary Clinton's emails. We could see the emails back in 2011 between her and Sidney Blumenthal, okay? Talking about why it was necessary to take out Gaddafi. Now, they've got a lot of oil, have a lot of water there, massive freshwater underground supply there. But that wasn't really the core thing that they were after. It always goes back to the bankers, doesn't it? In every war, it goes back to the bankers. And they said, these sanctions aren't really going to work. Because Gaddafi has been stockpiling gold and silver. He's got about 143 tons of each. Because he was going to back his currency with gold. You know, the French, he wanted to go in competition with the French franc, with the American dollar, with the petrodollar that we created with the Saudi Arabians. I said he wants to establish a pan-African currency based on the Libyan dinar backed with gold. The plan was designed to provide the African countries, the Francophone African countries, the ones that had been under the dominance of the colonial powers. And you have to understand, they are still colonial powers. They're just trying to mask it, and they're trying to create chaos on both sides. They don't want competition with their fiat currencies. That's why they started this all. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, and we're going to go back to how Hillary founded ISIS. And we're going to tell you how she ran guns, the big gun control lady, big gun runner. We're going to tell you how she helped to, she was warned about the black genocide that was going to happen in Libya. Didn't do anything about it. Didn't do anything to stop it. So here's this lady who says that she doesn't like guns, that she loves black people, but she supported a genocide against black people in Libya. This is the lady who tells us she's for women's rights, but she cozies up to all of these Sharia people. Absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing that she gets away with all this. Before we go back to the news, though, I want to remind you that we have a way for you to prepare for crisis, for bad weather. Whatever happens, you need to take advantage of the products that you can find that are going to help you to prepare for the unexpected, okay? We have an off-the-grid mega special that's going on right now at InfoWarsLife.com, starting with Silver Bullet, colloidal silver. We have 50% off, and I'm glad they've got that there because I just ran out of colloidal silver myself. I use it for a lot of things. So if I'm starting to feel sick, especially when I'm traveling, I take the silver when I'm doing that. Or if I even cut myself, I put silver on it. I don't get infected anymore. This is a well-known fact that you can see hospitals starting to use silver and bandages and other things. This is something that has been well-known for a very long time, how effective that is in a number of ways, topically or internally. And again, 50% off Silver Bullet. You can find that at InfoWarsLife.com. Also, many other things that are not health-related we have on special right now. We have 20% off all Alexa Pure water filters. 20% off. That's from the smallest to the largest. That's at InfoWarsStore.com. Also, 33% off the solar base station power supply. That is a solar collector, a photovoltaic collector, as well as a battery backup and inverter that you can hook that together up as a system for a backup power supply. That's now 33% off at InfoWarsStore.com. It's transportable, so you can take it with you, a part of your bug-out preparations, if you wish. Also, the InfoWars Premium Power Pack, 20% off at InfoWarsStore.com. That's a small box that can crank your car. I know, because I've had to do that. It's far better to do that than it is to take the risk of blowing out your alternator if you do it in the dark. It's much easier to do it with this thing. Get it set up and then turn this on, and it has the power to crank your car as well as to charge any of your devices. So 20% off that. A lot of specials you'll find at the off-the-grid mega special at InfoWarsLife.com, including a massive discount off of Silver Bullet colloidal silver. Now, as I was just talking about before we went to the break, the very fact that the New York Times would come out and say that we've got a proxy war going on, that we're losing it, that we're on the side of ISIS, that the CIA has trained and equipped and continues to supply ISIS. And we were doing really good until the Russians came in. We were going to win with our ISIS forces, with Al-Qaeda, just like we'd won with Al-Qaeda against the Russians in Afghanistan. Now we call them ISIS, but, you know, they always like to say it's ISIL, ISIL. Because, you know, if you say it's the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria, it kind of gives you an idea that we created ISIS to go against Syria. And we were talking about what was going on with the reasons why they overthrew Gaddafi in Libya. We were talking about that 5 years ago. Everybody was talking about that 5 years ago when it happened, 2011. And we reported, as well as New American and others reported, look, Gaddafi has been saying that he's going to set up this gold-backed currency. He's going to go in competition to the central banks, the fiat currencies on the West. That would have devastated the dollar, would have devastated the petrodollar, because he would have had his own oil-based dollar that was also backed by gold. Ours is backed by nothing but our relationship with these murderers in Saudi Arabia. So that was a very dangerous thing. It was dangerous for us. They said, hey, the French are going to come in too because they still see themselves as a colonial power in north of Africa. And they're concerned. They don't want Gaddafi joining with sub-Saharan Africa. And so that was a large part of what happened there. But then there were emails that have been released now by WikiLeaks that shows that, yes, what we were talking about at InfoWars, what the New American was talking about, what others were talking about, not the mainstream media at the time, our analysis of it saying, hey, I think this is about the gold-backed currency. Now we see the emails between Sidney Blumenthal and Hillary Clinton saying, this is about the gold-backed currency. So it's like the NSA whistleblowers telling us right after 9/11, people like William Binney, Thomas Drake, warning us that the government was going to use the 9/11 situation to go after all of our privacy, to do dragnet surveillance. But then people didn't believe it until 2000 and what was it, 12, when Snowden came out? I think it was 12 when he came out, maybe 13. They didn't believe it for a dozen years, okay, until they saw the documents. So now we have the documents. They're going after them because of the gold-backed currency competing with our fiat currency, our central bank. The fact that they were running guns to terrorists, they talk about. The fact that the people that we were backing were going to be shooting on sight what they called foreigners in Libya. How did they recognize the foreigners at sight? How did they know just by sight that they're foreigners? Well, because they're black. See, they understood that the people that they would identify as being black were the sub-Saharans that Gaddafi was trying to help, that he was working with to create this Pan-African alliance. So these people are Arab terrorists that we were using as proxies, as surrogates, were going to shoot on sight anybody with black skin. There's Hillary Clinton for you. Yeah, that's Hillary Clinton. And as we look at what's going on now in Turkey as well, Turkey is now starting to move towards Russia. If you remember when the coup happened, okay, they shut down the American military base. Major air base there in Turkey has a lot of nuclear weapons. They cut the power off for over a week. They isolated the air base. They isolated the Americans there. And they began talking to Russia. And they said at the same time, we believe, whether this is true or not, Erdogan was saying, we want Fethullah Gulen. We think that it's his people, his forces, people loyal to him that began this coup. And we want you to turn over Gulen. They've had a civil war for quite some time. It hasn't turned into a shooting war except just occasionally. And most recently was the biggest event of that. But there has been this civil war essentially going on between Erdogan and Gulen. Both of them, by the way, both of them radical Islamicists. Both of them want an Islamic caliphate. Neither of them are good guys, okay? But we have a lot of ties to Fethullah Gulen. Erdogan, who has isolated this base, who is now making overtures to Russia, essentially sending signals to us that he's going to shut down that U.S. military base. What he wants is Gulen extradited. But the American government isn't going to give him Gulen. Not even to save their nuclear air base there in Turkey. That's how important he is to them. And who else is he important to? It's not just to Obama, but also to Hillary Clinton. Okay, we got a recent article from Breitbart talking about how the lawyer for Erdogan that has been coming after Gulen here in America, Robert Amsterdam, said Gulen's Islamicist cult buys off U.S. politicians in both parties to avoid investigations. Okay, well, we've been warned by this by both the left and the right. We've had the Daily Caller on the right, and we've had the Daily Beast on the left, both telling us about the ties between Fethullah Gulen and Hillary Clinton. Hillary Clinton, okay? Hillary Clinton, the Daily Beast says, Fethullah Gulen just had a news conference in his compound in Pennsylvania, where he was praising Hillary Clinton and talking about his close relationships. He says she's very courteous, very kind. This is exactly what the Secret Service agents who protect her say, isn't it? No, it's not what they say. He says, before our meeting some years ago, President Clinton, Bill Clinton, was facing a difficult situation here in America. I wrote a letter to him encouraging him. He is such a successful president, and Hillary actually wrote a response to that letter. I find her to be very courteous and kind, a great hope for this country. And so the Daily Beast reports that. But also the Daily Caller back in November, and a lot of people have pointed out the fact that a former president of the Gulen-linked Turkish Cultural Center, Ozkan, gave between $500,000 and $1 million to the Clinton Foundation in recent months. He also served as the National Finance Co-Chair last year for a pro-Clinton political action committee called ReadyPAC. Now, how does this affect us, besides the fact that this is yet another example of a foreign government like Saudi Arabia, who bragged that they have given Hillary Clinton 20% of her campaign contributions. How does this affect us? Of course, we've seen Hillary Clinton choosing to have a Sharia lawyer, somebody who has abused the EB-5 visa program. She chose to have him speak just prior to her accepting the nomination. Why? Because, well, he would attack Donald Trump personally, and hopefully Donald Trump would take the bait, and he did, come after him, and then they would say, oh, he's against Muslims. Well, no, we're against Sharia law, okay? But she has this guy who is a Sharia lawyer, Sharia Khan. She also then has the guy that looks like Super Mario, the Taliban, who is behind her, the guy from Afghanistan, a Talibanist, and she has him sitting behind her, as we pointed out, as others have pointed out. You don't get to sit behind the candidate unless they know who you are, okay? So she has all that, and then she has this close relationship with Fethullah Gulen. So this is more than just foreign money coming in, folks. The Gulen people are connected to a network, and we've mentioned this many times, connected to a network of charter schools. Charter schools are kind of quasi, there he is, there's Super Mario over there, right, as you can see him there. Does he look like Super Mario? So he's perfectly harmless, you know, because he looks like Mario. The charter schools that are being run by the Gulenists in America are not overtly Islamic. They have more subtle ways to recruit people into the Turkish culture, into the Turkish religion, into the Turkish politics, okay? And they don't get overtly religious because they're getting $500 million. They've got about 140-some-odd schools in the United States. The bulk of them are in Texas. We've reported on this. We've had the fellow Mark Hall, who did the documentary Killing Ed. And by the way, that is something that was completely shut down at South by Southwest, even though it was a documentary that had national importance and was focused here in Texas. They didn't show it in South by Southwest. New York Times wouldn't review it. Now they're going to have a tour. They're going to have several Texas cities starting August 29th. They're going to be in Austin, Texas, then 30th in Houston, then in Dallas, San Antonio, El Paso. So check out their site. You need to understand what's going on with charter schools. You need to understand the danger for crony capitalism there. You need to understand that this is a situation where they operate as private schools, and yet they are publicly funded with taxpayer money. It is a perfect storm of crony capitalism. But the worst case scenario that he points out in this documentary is that somebody can take this over with an Islamic agenda, okay, which is what we're seeing. And even Peggy Noonan, who has not been very friendly to Donald Trump, has an op-ed piece in the Wall Street Journal, How the Global Elites Forsake Their Countrymen. And she's looking at Angela Merkel and what's going on there. And she says, you know, Mrs. Merkel moved unilaterally, announcing that Germany would take in an astounding 800,000 people last year. Naturally, this was taken as an invitation, and more than a million came. The result has been widespread public furor over the resulting crime, cultural dissimulation, fears of terrorism, not just fears of terrorism, folks, actual terrorism, okay? From such a sturdy, grounded character as Ms. Merkel, writes Peggy Noonan, the decision was puzzling. Okay, look. If she was sturdy and grounded, you have to understand, this is not a mistake, folks. We've pointed this out over and over again here at InfoWars. This is not a mistake. It's a plan. It's a plan. We see it. Peggy Noonan can't admit it yet. Okay, she just said it was puzzling. She was uncharacteristically romantic about people, how they live their lives and their history. You know, she just made a mistake. She's just this romantic person. Normally, she's very rational. She's very hard. She's very cold. She's very calculating. But here she just gave in to her romantic feminine side here. Just too much of a heart. You know, she just had a heart for these people. Couldn't help them in their country. Couldn't do anything to stop our surrogate proxy war that created this situation that I just talked about. Couldn't do anything to stop all that as a rational person. So her heart just got the better of her, and they all came into this country. No, it is not a mistake. It's not their heart getting the best of them. This is a plan. And as I pointed out on the nightly news, The people in Germany understand this as well. I read a an editorial that I translated from German, a rough translation with Google. And the guy was saying, this is the great people replacement. Understand that. We need to stop talking about it as open borders and immigration. It is a plan to replace the people. It has begun. They don't like the German people being in Germany. They don't like the American people being in America. They want to replace us with people that are more malleable, people who have lower expectations. Because as we see our standard of living declining, we're going to get upset. We're already upset. We already know what you're doing to us. We already know that when you talk about one world and a one world government and you want to make everybody the same, that doesn't mean that you want to lift up the people in the third world to our level. That means you're going to level us down to third world levels. You are destroying these countries because you want everybody leveled to the lowest possible denominator. You want a one world, not a first world and a third world, and you want everybody in that case to be at the third world level. That's what's going to happen with this. As a matter of fact, as I was looking at the editorial, he actually compared it to what a communist Bertolt Brecht saw in East Germany in 1953. The people there, ironically enough, they felt betrayed. You know, they had this communist government that said they were there for the people. Everybody was going to be treated the same, and yet they had minimum wage for some people, not for the elites who rule the country. And they said, you know, we can't live on this. The minimum wage is too low. Does that sound familiar? Does that sound like the Democrat Party's disillusioned constituents? And so what they did was they rioted. And what they got from the communist elite was an iron fist in their face. The military, the police, tanks, okay, put that down in 1953. And so as he looked at that, even the guy who liked communism looked at the ruthless repression of the people who said we need a higher minimum wage. And he said, well, I guess we can't dissolve parliament anymore, but parliament can dissolve the people. It's far easier that way, isn't it? What is happening right now in the West is the great people replacement. It is the great leveling that is going on. And even when you got somebody like Peggy Noonan saying, you know, she's trying, she means well. You know, she's usually very rational. Merkel is just attempting to provide some kind of a counterstatement about the great sin of the 20th century, the historical sin and the stain of Nazism. And it's like, no, that's not it. That's not it. It's not that kind of guilt. That's what they use on people. They use racism. They use that type of guilt. But that's not what's driving it in France. It's not what is driving Obama. He's not trying to get rid of the stain of Nazism here. He's trying to replace the people and to level us. Welcome back to our final segment of the Alex Jones Show, this fourth hour on this Friday. Before I get back to the news, and I want to talk a little bit about election fraud, because we had the guy call and challenge Alex about that. It really is there. Maybe you don't want to believe your eyes, but we're going to talk about that. But real quickly, we have a Get Off the Grid mega special that's going on right now at InfoWarsLife.com. Several devices, other things that are going to help you get electricity, water, and things like Silver Bullet, colloidal silver, 50% off Silver Bullet at InfoWarsLife.com, something that is very essential to have, especially in an emergency preparedness situation. Also, though, we have Alexa Pure water filters, 20% off at InfoWarsStore.com. That's a great thing to have. We use all, even though we're not on city water where we are, we use these Alexa Pure water filters because when I'm pulling this out of the well, I don't know which of my neighbors are using glyphosate or what is going down into the aquifer. I don't know. Who knows where the water is coming from? It's a mystery what's going on underground. And it's a mystery as to what's in your water. So take something that can get it all out. Whether you're on a municipal system and you have to worry about the stuff that they're deliberately putting in there, like chlorine and fluorides, or if you're out in a rural area and you don't know what kind of chemicals and runoff are in that, this will get it out. 20% off all Alexa Pure water filters. We also have the InfoWars solar base station power supply. That is a battery and inverter, as well as solar panels to charge that battery and provide electricity for you. It's portable as well. That is 33% off. And then the small physical size small, but it packs a huge charge. The premium power pack is 20% off at InfoWarsStore.com. So check out our off-the-grid mega special at InfoWars Life and InfoWarsStore.com. We have huge savings on things to prepare for emergencies of any sort. You know, we had the caller who said, hey, prove that there is fraud going on. And as I've mentioned before, the last election, 2012, friend of my brother-in-law's said that he went to vote and they told him that he had already voted along with his dead mother, because all you have to do is walk in and give them a name and an address, okay? And we can see when we look at James O'Keefe and others, I mean, we've got the CBS News going there showing you the electronic voting machine and saying, look, here's how I can manipulate this thing. And that's not the first time that's happened. We've had mainstream media show us for years. There's some really old video that's been going back 10, 15 years. And by the way, a lot of the voting machines are 10 or 15 years old as well, okay, which means that they are incredibly vulnerable to fraud. But if we show you somebody walking in and giving them a false name and they know that it's false and he says, hey, you know, I don't have any ID, just let me vote. And I say, okay, fine, sure, yeah, we'll let you vote. Just sign this paper affirming that that's who you are and we'll let you vote. When you see that happen, when you see the voting machines being rigged live on television, and when we tell you firsthand that this is happening, do stores have to use voter ID only after they've had people rip them off multiple times by writing bad checks or doing other things? Of course not. They understand that's a possibility. And if you show them how easy it is to do that, they would be fools not to do that. And yet, when they try to enact voter ID, when they say, we're going to require you to show us some picture ID in order to vote in North Carolina, they say, that's racist. Okay? It's also racist, they say, if they gerrymander the districts. And that was something that happened for the Republicans. They got to draw the district lines for the first time in 2010. Never got a chance to do that before the Republicans. And immediately they said, well, that's going against the black vote. Well, 90% of the people who are black are voting for the Democrats. And yes, they were trying to bias this in favor of the Republicans instead of the Democrats. I don't like gerrymandering laws. I think that would just go with contiguous geographical regions. But every time they do something to change the voting laws, and there's no reason you wouldn't have voter IDs, it's racist. It's racist. That's what we hear. All right, join us tonight, 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern, for the InfoWars Nightly News. Leanne McAdoo will be hosting.